pick Azir for Coco if they can get it, if Najin's not going to ban the Azir themselves.
But with Coco having a much larger champion pool than Goong, okay, they're just going to ban the Victor right off the bat.
So I think I know what's coming here.
Kalista, the first ban for Najin. So you think they're going to go for an Azir first pick for Coco. I think that's a pretty likely thing.
So Alistar. So this says they're not going to first pick the Alistar for Mad Life, and they don't want Pure to have it, considering he has had an emphasis on that champion this season. So Gragas will be unavailable for Ambition. And now I would assume we're going to see a second mid lane ban here. If you're going to bother to ban the Victor, you should probably take out the Cassiopeia too.
Yeah. Hey, Goong has been pretty adequate on Cassiopeia. Although we haven't seen much
Azir
of it lately anyway. Interesting. So I thought they were going to go for a first pick Azir. With Coco's performance, it would not have been surprising. There's a Ryze ban finishing things off.
Yeah, Coco just has a much more expansive champion pool. So
yeah.
He apparently probably has an answer to the Cassiopeia. We haven't seen as much Cassiopeia these days.
Do you think they'd go for the Ezreal right now?
They could. Obviously, Space fine at playing that champion in the bottom lane.
The Woong special from back in the day.
Well,
the famous arcane shifts into the fight.
It was special. Warmog's armor, or Warmog's on the Ezreal.
It was special day every day. Well, everyone was buying Warmog's back then.
Not 80 carries, Della.
Everyone was buying Warmog's. And they may go with this Rek'Sai. What do you think about that? I think that's a bit risky. Because if you go Maokai Ezreal with Najin, that might put CJ in a tight spot already.
I'm not in disagreement with you, Doa, but the question remains, can Goong actually play this mid lane Ezreal? Could go back to Twisted Fate, another champion that Coco actually carried them against Jhin Air with very recently. If Coco hadn't had a good performance that game, Jhin Air was definitely going to win that.
Yeah.
So maybe going for the Echo for Watch. I think Sivir is a much stronger choice, but showing the TF early may be a bit of a mistake. And there's the Rumble instead for Duke. Probably a wiser choice.
Yeah, I mean, if you pick the TF now, that just gives CJ way too much of an opportunity to counter it. The Maokai going to be the safer way to go. So Sivir Maokai, two strong pickups for Najin. And this also does make the Ezreal a little bit riskier for CJ to grab as well.
Sure, absolutely. The Sivir Maokai, good counter for that. And Duke also. Shy is not exactly going to be... I mean, I've seen Shy play Fizz, and granted it was Cinderhulk Fizz, but that was one of CJ's worst games of the season.
Yeah.
And if you're Duke, maybe you're not worried about Shy's Fizz, which is the answer that many Korean teams, even in our last set we saw, executing that lane counter pick against the Maokai and then just having the jungler camp for them to pick up kills. It's just not a lot Maokai can do against Fizz.
Well, Shy could certainly play the Rumble.
But if you're Duke, it's actually, I think for Najin, just a very safe Maokai, because you don't have a guy like Marin or someday on the enemy team who's going to bash you in. And
whoa.
A Graves.
Oh, interesting. Wow, Graves Rumble.
So this is a big mid-game burst composition. We have been seeing more Graves, especially in Europe.
Yeah, it seemed like it never really left Europe altogether, but we have not seen it in Korea for a while.
Yes, it has been quite some time. There's been some speculation that Graves would be coming back on 5.13 a little bit as bursty 80 carries were going to be maybe coming back into play, I've seen from a few people, but... we're still on 5.12, so this is... I think... You know what I think this is, Doa? I think this is just CJ playing for the mid-game against Najin and trying to have a lane bully to counteract the presence of OQ. So they're just going to put space on something that's easy to execute against the Sivir.
Seems reasonable.
And not get just bashed in the bottom lane. But Annie actually falls through. Watch is going to get his Evelynn.
All right, and so what are the last two picks for CJ going to be then? What do you put with this Graves? Braum would give you a very, very tanky bully lane. And I'd love to see the mid lane Misfortune, but I don't think we're going to see that.
I don't know if you actually need the Braum here.
What if it's a mid Graves?
Anything's possible.
It's going to be a weird Thresh, name.
Thresh would be quite strong here. Thresh would be quite strong because you can set up picks with the Rumble and Graves burst pretty nicely.
Yeah, true.
Thinking about, we've seen mid Karma this season from Spenu. We've also seen top Karma this from Spenu. We've seen support Karma from the Ku Tigers. But the Ezreal might be the grab. Now, this is an insane burst comp.
No
now,
kidding.
And this also can assassinate a backline from the front because you have True Shot Barrage, Equalizer, and Collateral Damage all just annihilate, just pass straight through to the carries.
Oh, man. I suddenly love this comp. It's going to be very entertaining to watch in team fights. The team fights are going to be very short. We'll put it that way. Wow, Zed locked in by Goon.
All right. Well, so we're back to that, apparently. This is where Goon is going today. He feels confident in playing against the Ezreal. And Ezreal, with this Runeglaive, he just can't take heal or barrier, any of the things that help him against Zed.
Yeah, very true. He just got to stay out of the way.
And you know this is a risk when you play against Goon, but we haven't seen a whole lot of Zed since the nerfs. Goon has played it, though, as has Mickey.
And I mean, if anything, Goon is going to be very comfortable on an Assassinate again.
I don't know about this, because the main concern here with the Zed is now that there is that cooldown on returning to his shadow after he ults in, if he ults in, the amount of burst that Coco and Graves can kill him before he can escape, for sure. So this is a bit risky. They will have a strong 4-1 split, and Shy is going to have a difficult time itemizing because he is going to be dealing with magic damage in lane, but then a split-pushing Zed in the mid-game. So how is he going to build this Rumble? He needs both Abyssal and Zhonya, as one would presume.
Would you maybe just lane swap and go for armor right away?
But there's no guarantee, because eventually you're going to have to swap it. You will be laning against the Maokai at a certain point, so getting armor right away may be kind of inefficient.
Well, we will see who can handle it. A playoff battle begins. CJ versus Najin, game number one. Let's get in the game. Welcome to Summoner's Rift. CJ Entis versus Najin Yemfire. And as we talked about earlier, very, very realistically, a playoff spot could be on the line right now between these two teams. It is a very, very tight race.
And therefore a world spot, too. Now,
yep.
Likely, with the way the playoffs are stacking up right now and CJ finishing in third place last season, they have at least enough circuit points to get in the gauntlet under most normal circumstances. So even if they don't make playoffs, they will still have a shot, albeit a long one, to make the world championships. But Najin, they were on the outside looking in at the playoffs last time, so they must go to the playoffs if they want to get anywhere close to Worlds.
It's going to be tough. Najin, I feel like, has made some, certainly made some strides this season as opposed to last season. But of late, looking a bit weak.
Well, and you have to wonder, too, because armor, basically, once the Thorn Mails come in, well, there's only going to be one Thorn Mail, I suppose, onto Ambition in the very late game. But once the armor comes in for CJ, there are not very many options for Najin to actually deal damage.
I mean, you just go Thornmail Graves and dual OQ. There you go.
You got it.
Got the plan. That's right. It'll be interesting to see how this lane turns out. We'll see if Goon is able to get some sort of all-in going around level 6 or something.
So OQ coming back late here from the Gromp camp, helping out, and like you said, we will have the 2v2 in this one. Not sure exactly what Goon thinks he's going to do. And
wow, look at Space being aggressive. Don't see that every day.
Well,
but with that Graves, I mean, you can be.
Yes, Sivir doesn't have spell shield yet, so you could just walk up and buckshot her in the face.
Yeah. I mean, it's certainly a bit of a bully lane. A lot of tankiness. The trades are going to certainly go in CJ's favor early on.
And there we see. Or is this mic coming down early for Coco? So just going to maintain control of this. Now, most teams think that the way to control the Ezreal is just to put him against a wave clear mage early and just force him back into his tower so that he loses some CS and that you can get an advantage on the map. But I'm not sure that's going to really be able to work here. I'm not very confident in Najin's composition with this Zed, but I have also seen times where Goon just goes off on Zed and it doesn't matter because he has like 8 kills.
Yeah, it seems very dangerous to underestimate Goon's Zed. We've seen some pretty good games in the past from that. And Madlife just zoning with that Q. Pretty effective tool for that.
And Najin also has a very all-in composition. Everybody is going to be in the front line attempting to do something. And if Goon can just be patient while the rest of his team engages with the Sivirolt, maybe they can blow enough cooldowns that he has a bit of an easier time getting a flank onto the squishy carries, or if they simply use their cooldowns in a way that they no longer have an opportunity to burst him, it'd be quite effective. Of course, these are not Runeglaive stats from Coco. These are AD Ezreal stats from Spring, by the way.
Yep. Not as applicable. But Goon stats still frightening either way.
So here we go.
Yeah, a gank coming in onto Coco. He could be in a little bit of trouble here. He has no idea.
He's got a backup. His jungler's there, but he doesn't know there are two people here.
Yeah, that's right. Coco trying to get away immediately with the flash, getting very, very low. Ambition coming in, and Madlife, or Pure rather, grabs that first blood.
So that
I
was...
I wanted to be Madlife, I guess.
That was a bit... It was a nice gank, but, you know, without Annie in that bottom lane, you have to have a bit of worry that that's going to happen because they need this Zed to get rolling, and they know they want to shut down the Ezreal. Fortunately for CJ, Zed doesn't actually get the kill, and he was the one who used the Ignite too, so that does relieve a bit of pressure from the lane.
Yeah.
And Coco's going to be forced to go for an arm guard first instead of actually building directly into Runeglaive. So that's going to slow this Ezreal down even more. And it affects his wave clear because he doesn't have that Ranger's Trailblazer for the AoE smite. So this could open up Goon to some pretty fancy roaming in the early game.
Well, either way, at least no flashes burned on the side of CJ to get away from that. Flash used by Watch in that case.
Oh, Watch
getting caught and no flash. Turns out that's pretty important as he's going to get taken out. Ambition with the kill there. The exhaust onto Goon now. He's in a bit of trouble. Tries to flash away, but now no escape. Here comes Space, who gets the kill. Looks like it's going to go to Coco. They want to even up that mid lane.
Just handing it to Coco right there. And that was such a dangerous face check.
Oh, man.
From Watch. So greedy, not even... Both teams not even thinking about where the enemy support could be in these situations. First, we see Najin getting the roam off with Pure, and then Madlife had recalled, and certainly he could be walking into mid to ward right now, because especially when you're playing against an Evelynn, you have to assume that the support is also potentially going to be dropping a pink ward around the mid lane so you can get full coverage for Coco.
Right. Oh, to Chaparaj. Oh, did he get the wolves? I didn't see if he got it.
No, he didn't.
Would have been cool.
Style points for the Evelynn ward. Although, well, the downside is that now you have let Evelynn know that you know that there is a ward there in case Watch didn't know that already.
It's true.
So that's something he can play around in the future. Okay. And now the safe timing to go in for Watch when there is, in fact, not a mid laner in mid lane.
Well, Coco got his... Seeker's arm guard extremely quickly because of that kill. And so he shouldn't be actually slowed down all that much, I guess.
And Goon also went for a Vamp Scepter first, so he doesn't have any armor penetration. That is just sustaining for the moment, just trying to deal with the poke, but that's going to let Coco stack that arm guard with relative impunity.
Well, the mid lane battle continues, and Space's roam up to help out with that kill, too, is really nice.
Yep, now he has a BF sword instead of the pickaxe, and that's huge.
Yep. Lane going very well for him so far, despite being down a little bit in CS, but the assist should make up for that.
Well, he's got an extra wave, too, so he'll be up in CS by the time everything settles down.
True enough.
Trisha Barrage going through, and there's a blue buff for Goon.
A blue buff for Goon. This fall on the Hallmark Channel.
Buffs for Goon.
That's right.
Well, that would probably be an assassin patch, realistically.
Yeah, yeah. You don't want to buff Goong at this point, because that would mean all the assassins would come back.
I'm okay with
that.
Which
is fun. It's fun to watch. It's fun to watch, but Goong's opponents would not like that.
Well, next patch, though, it's going to be about the slow burn. It's actually like the GBM patch. It's kind of funny.
Oh, boy. They just want to get this guy
Leandri
to Worlds,
man. And Rylai's on everybody.
Oh, GBM's wanted to go to Worlds for a long time, so there we go. Here's the chance now. Oh, a little bit of trading going in, but Space immediately just walks right back up and does more damage to OQ.
Really tough situation for OQ. He's handling it pretty well, actually, going even in this lane to this juncture.
Mm-hmm. Hasn't died yet, which is nice. So he's got that going for him.
Wow, so very passive build. Avarice Blade will be the buy on the recall, so he's pretty much just given up on winning this lane. Instead, just going to try and farm as best as he can and get a little more money in the process.
I feel like this is exactly what CJ wants, though. You know, they want
Najin
to come into a pretty weak mid game.
I agree, and CJ's set up for that. And even Zed is going to take a while to get going.
Yeah. Well, especially again, you know, with that Vamp Scepter start.
So they're really, I think, just going to be looking for the split push with the Zed if they can get it. That, if Najin can execute that to a degree where they get a couple of towers, maybe they can do something. But the exhaust on CJ going to be reserved for Goon Zed because there's not really another good target for it. And again, there's so much burst out of CJ that any pick that CJ makes is going to be devastating in the mid game.
Yeah, well, nice dodging for Space. Ah, they're trying to bait them in. Pure gets a stun on a Mad Life. Watches there, but doesn't look like they're going to go in on that. They use the Sivir ult even.
Yeah, just a little bit scared, but no summoners even used by CJ on that level 6. They could try again right now.
Oh, there's a ward. He's going to see the pink ward, but
where's the Evelyn?
Oh, I was going to say. That watch was right there.
No, he backed out of that.
Oh, Mad Life does not know he's playing as dangerously as he is right there.
Well, he is quite tanky, and he does have a Rumble with Equalizer ready to teleport to him.
That does help.
Should he need that level of assistance?
Yeah, Shy doing just fine up in this top lane. A little bit down on CS, but not the biggest deal. So far, the finger's holding up.
Looks like the finger's doing fine this game.
It's been an injury-filled year, apparently, between Tucson and, or what rather, Wisdom and Peekaboo and
well, just the other
Sasan and Shy. And
yeah, a lot of the other regions, too. We haven't really had this many injuries before.
Yeah.
Of course, High from Cloud9 having some issues with his wrist.
Right.
It's been it's not been a good year for injuries and LoL.
Time to do those wrist exercises between solo queue games, guys.
Yeah, you actually should do that.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, Equalizer used to push through the wave. Shy doing a bit of damage to Duke up here. Yeah, really, your wrist feels so much better if you do that consistently, too.
Yeah, it's very important so you don't end up with fun, lifelong injuries.
Take it from a guy that had a ton of wrist pain like 4 years ago. And I just, like, changed my posture and did exercise and it completely went away.
Wow.
Haven't had it since, yeah.
Lucky you.
And it was, like, really bad for a year or so. So do them. Look them up online and do them. Do them right now. You don't need to wait.
You don't. You can do them while you do multitask.
Do wrist exercises while you watch Champions.
But thank you, Dr. Doa.
You're welcome. Dr. Doa is here to prescribe video games and wrist exercises to support more video gameplay.
Truly ruining the youth of today, Doa.
That's right. Just like rock and roll music and pool.
Pool?
Yeah, yeah. Back in like the 30s, you know, pool halls.
Oh, yeah.
Not like swimming pools, like billiards.
Did billiards ruin the youth of the 30s?
Clearly.
I thought that was more like prohibition alcohol.
Maybe. Oh, meanwhile, Mad Life a little bit caught here, trying to get away. Uses that Braum ultimate, gets a knockup. Space trying to do some damage on the way out. Tippers is chasing. Run. Wow, makes it out just barely.
Yep, not even Summoner Heal having to be used by Space.
No.
I suppose Prohibition was more the 20s, by the way.
Oh, was it? Okay. Sounds good. I wasn't alive then, so.
Doa's knowledge of American history, everybody.
I don't know. We can drink now, so it's all good. So do those wrist exercises. it looks like Blue Buff's going to be handed off to Zed. A little bit of CDR.
Did Zed get it or did Eve take it?
I think Zed got it.
Oh, I didn't see.
Pretty sure. Monty's knowledge of who got the Blue Buff, everybody. See? Look, it's Zed.
I didn't see it all the quick. I was looking at something else on the screen.
Oh, sure.
Jeez.
Okay.
You were looking at something else for your entirety of American history.
Hey,
boom!
Sure, I'm sure I remembered that at one point. Oh, flash stun onto Coco. There's a death mark, and he is probably not going to live. Oh, never mind. Yep, Goon goes in for the kill.
Mad life there, but he just can't protect him in the end. Goon actually surviving with just a small amount of health. Mad life wasn't there in time to actually get the exhaust off, and now Pure.
What you doing, buddy?
He's trying to find Ambition. Ambition is lurking in the jungle.
Ambition's like, is there a ward on me?
He's waiting to shoot.
Comes in, gets a knock up. Pure in a little bit of trouble, but turret damage coming. Oh, here's Mad Life.
He missed
a Q.
No, he hit the Q.
Mad Life?
No, he
missed the Q, yeah.
Yeah, definitely didn't hit the Q.
Monty's observation, people being hit by Qs, everybody. Look out, you're on camera. Whoa, that was a ult from space. No, actually, it was an ult from Graves, who is also named Space.
An ult from Space.
It looked like it was an ult from Space, the way it just kind of randomly came in there. Nice try.
That was actually quite clever by Ambition. Nice attempt, but no dice this time. So Runeglaive finally finished for Coco. The delays to his build, are they over? Is Goon enough ahead? Stay tuned for more Champion Summer.
Wow. People would be really mad if we took a commercial break right now. Got to make those monies. Oh, the battle to take the ward. It's not going to go well for Mad Life. With Watch right there, this could be very dangerous. They're going to pop the Sivir ult. Don't really know what direction they want to go, though, I guess. They just know they wanted to ult. All right, Mad Life
ult party.
Press R.
Just run around in a circle. It's running around a circle is much better when you can do it very quickly.
Press R for run. That's four. Well, that was anticlimactic.
So, Coco's nice and bottled up right now, even though he has that blue buff. And what is this Zed going to do? He's got to be able to make a play. In spite of the Maokai to Rumble matchup, we've seen no ganks in the top side. And Shy getting pretty strong. And CJ...
Well, there we go. Knock up onto... Goon could be in a little bit of trouble. Tries to go in for the death mark onto Coco, but it's not enough damage. Coco lives through that one. That's a kill for Ambition.
Yep, just getting there nice and early, and the armor doing its work right now. Even though the Hex Drinker was popped to delay some of the damage from Coco, Ambition smartly just goes, there we go, gets the smite down, and then the last hit.
Yep, a little bit down on CS, so the kills, the assists, the smiting of the jungle camp certainly helping Coco keep up in gold.
Yep, Watch is waiting right here to make sure that none of this CS goes to waste while Ambition takes care of some of the mid lane wards. Mad Life on a deep warding mission at the same time after they see Evelynn, so really thorough warding of the Najin jungle. This is something that was really lacking in their games against KT Rolster.
Yeah, that's true.
When Ambition did not have such a good day in the jungle.
Yeah, certainly looking better today on this Rek'Sai.
And CJ's ahead. They are in a very good place in spite of all of Najin's focus on the mid lane. Zed hasn't really been able to move out anywhere and try and take control or snowball another lane with the Zed. They haven't gotten a tower down yet, and so they're just kind of waiting it out. But as Zed gets strong, by the time Zed gets where Zed needs to be, we may see Coco getting close to a Luden's Echo or something that is going to be very effective. And they're going to be able to build QSS or Zonias on Shy and Space and Coco. And that means that there are no ult targets for Zed in the late game. Just absolutely none.
Yeah.
Don't want to ult a Braum. Don't want to ult a Rek'Sai. That's rather pointless. Oh, is this going to be the second time this happens today?
Apparently, but there's no vision this time for
the
enemy
team. No,
there's
a ward. They saw the tunnel go in.
Oh.
So will Goon strike?
Oh yeah, they saw the tunnel going in, I see. Nope, doesn't look like it. CJ gets an easy first strike, and Ambition just takes it by himself. Not bad. Yeah, and Coco, obviously, the wave clear getting much, much better for him now.
Well, the Zed has to do something soon. The Zed doesn't do something soon and start to create a really big lead, then it's probably just going to be lights out because CJ, their siege is going to be very strong. They could just bully you off of turrets by using the three ults on Ezreal, Graves, and Rumble and just take towers for free after that because Najin is not going to be able to withstand that level of poke and stay on an objective.
Yeah, I mean, really, Maokai, the only tanky member of Najin. Ambition, he should be okay. Yep, just takes the tunnel.
He has Ambition tunnels in reserve.
That's right.
Oh,
Madeline. Ult onto Pure. OQ getting very low as well, too, via space. There's the ult. Madlife takes the kill from space. Oh, well.
Wow, just splitting him up and turning that around very easily. Madlife walks forward in the lane, gets the initiation, and considering that the Rek'Sai was still there and waiting, we're going to try and force them off the tower right now. So CJ well on their way this game.
Sure enough. Looks like they should be able to get the bottom turret as well.
Yeah, very easily, in fact.
Whoa. Meanwhile, Watch gets found, and Madlife's going to come in there as well. They're going to get the stun from the passive. Watch in a lot of trouble. True Shot Barrage goes way wide. I don't think they thought about that stun.
TP,
teleporting down there. Yeah, Goom trying to find an opportunity to go in. Madlife very, very low. Space unloading onto Duke, but he's so tanky already. Madlife somehow escapes for the moment anyway.
Yeah, managed to get the Braum stun down and then flash over the wall. So both TPs used, but turret goes down. CJ gets the kill, and nothing at all happens for Najin Empire.
Yeah, Goom just could not find an angle to get in, and the fact that he's already struggling like that is really worrisome for the late game for Najin.
Yes, indeed it is. So Space already sitting on that Infinity Edge. He is much stronger than OQ at this point in time.
Yeah.
So OQ trying to catch up. The sustained damage will be better in the late game.
Yeah, but
so Najin still has a chance. You know,
you just think about what happens when this becomes a 5v5 fight. CJ unloads all their ultimates into Najin. Najin takes a ton of damage, and then they really can't fight. They can't defend turrets, and they can't fight.
I mean, I really like this composition from CJ because you have the Graves and the Rumble to get your Ezreal into the late game.
Yeah, it's really cool.
You have the AD burst, so there's not an efficient way for them to itemize against it compared to a Corki. Obviously, the Corki has more frequent poke, but the Graves poke is devastating if you issue an entire combo. And Graves has the smoke screen, so he provides some peel, actually, for the team. And he can really shut down flanks or choke points.
Well, they want to catch Madlife here, but they're not going to be able to. Nope.
Now, the problem with Graves is he's very low range, so you have Maokai and Annie to deal with in that regard.
Yeah. But if they have to end up using things on, say, a Rek'Sai coming in, that allows Space a chance to get close enough. Madlife as well, I suppose, can be a bit of a front line.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and Shy getting his Zhonya's very quickly, so he can even contribute a bit in that regard himself.
Yeah, I think that the fast Zhonya's here is... I'm surprised he didn't have to itemize for a little bit of MR against Maokai, but apparently he's making it work, and considering that he knows that the only timing that this Zed is going to have is that you get the split push off, but Zhonya's already finished for Coco, too. Which means that as long as nobody gets armor anytime soon, Space can actually third item a QSS.
Wow.
And then that's it. There is no winning for this Zed anymore. Unless CJ makes a massive mechanical misplay.
Oh, they're going after this tier one, and no one's really there to support Goom, so they're going to lose it. Pure looking for an ult here. Madlife zoning Watch very, very nicely finds him. That passive stun is going to be trouble. There comes a burst. Space with a kill there. Two-man Timber stun, but no follow-up for Najin. Goom coming in. Deathmark onto Space. He could be in a lot of trouble. There's the exhaust. Doesn't matter. Space goes down anyway. Goom gets a kill, but gets taken out by Ambition. Now OQ in a lot of trouble. Can't get the kill on Madlife before Coco takes him down. And that is 4-for-1 in favor of CJ and that turret as well.
And that was actually a big misplay from Watch. So what happened was he actually hit his W before the slow landed from Braum, before the Winter's Bite hit. So he wasn't able to clear that ability anymore, which led to the rest of CJ being able to catch up to him in that engagement. And then we just see the power of the exhaust against the Zed this early. There's not a way to clear it, and the burst was just massive.
Oh, yeah. Oku is blown up so fast.
Yeah, watch this.
Fight.
So Watch used his W early, which means that, nope, everybody's on top of him immediately. And even though there was a two-man Tibbers on his base at Gogo, great Tibbers from Pure, it's just they can't do anything. The Zonias goes down for Coco. Sure, they kill space, but just waits it out, and then they have enough follow-up crowd control in the skirmish between Braum and Rek'Sai to easily allow those carries to continue to unload their DPS.
Good focusing of targets by CJ as well, too. They didn't get distracted at all by OQ coming in. And
well fought, for sure.
Yeah, and that's what CJ does. They fight really well in the mid-game and late-game, and it's certainly paying off for them against Najin so far. Dragging up in a few seconds.
Hope is probably dead for Najin now.
That's going to be tough.
Coming at 23 minutes, you're 5,000 gold behind.
Oh, Coco going for a very fast Zonias as well, too.
Yeah, I was talking about that. The double Zonias. Yeah. And if Space can go for a QSS, depending on how Duke builds.
Nope, Sun on Ambition, he could be in a little bit of trouble here. Goon going in. Wow, Deathmark on Ambition, that was a bit overly bold. But here comes the rest of Najin, so they might have a chance here. Duke going deep, but Madlife zoning quite well. The stuns from Braum are helping so much in Space. Picks up a kill with the ultimate. True Shot Barrage
comes
through, doesn't
Ezreal.
Hit anyone. But Ezreal can do a lot more damage. That great equalizer, double kill for Space. It's going to be a double kill for Coco as well. Make that an ace as Ambition picks up the last one. A perfect ace for CJ, and they're going to grab the dragon as well. Welcome to Stomp Town.
And remember, Coco and Shy were not even there for the start of the fight.
Yeah.
Goon tries to ult the Rek'Sai. The Rek'Sai already has Rando and Zoman. He knows there are no more targets.
That was also a fight where I don't believe True Shot Barrage actually hit anybody.
No, it didn't.
So even when you... They didn't even
Watch
have that
this.
Big damage from True
So
Shot Barrage.
They think it's going to be, because Duke was there, this 4-on-3, basically. But there's so much tankiness from CJ, and Space is able to kite because they keep going into the choke. True Shot Barrage totally misses.
Whoa, we anticipated the move from Zed, too.
Wow.
With that Mystic Shot.
That was
Coco.
Beautiful.
Oh, man. What a beautiful fight from CJ. You know, a lot of teams are good at team fighting, but I've always loved watching CJ.
Yeah, that's definitely one of their strengths. When you get so many veteran players together on one team that have been through so many different games of League of Legends, especially people like Ambition and Shy and Madlife who have been around forever.
Yeah.
They know how to make this work, and CJ looking quite dominant here.
It's hard to find a team as in sync as CJ is in team fights. Well, Space just moving up to the top lane. They want to finish off the last of the outer turrets of Najin here, but a trap has been set. Oh, but they figured out.
So if Oh, wow.
Ambition getting caught completely, though. Got to get out of there. Duke coming in with Goong as well. Coco laying down some damage. Needs a True Shot Barrage. Doesn't have the cooldown, and they're going to just pick off Ambition. Whoops.
Well, Ambition going on those solo warding missions that he likes to die for frequently.
Dangers of warding.
Dangers of warding alone when you don't have vision.
Yeah.
An Ambition jungle story.
Sure enough. Coco's almost got that Luden's Echo now as well, too, so that'll be a nice little boost in damage.
Well, they managed to delay the Ezreal build pretty significantly by getting him that Zonya's Hourglass first, but... not probably going to matter too much at this point. There we go. Just another True Shot Barrage coming through on some wave clear. And now Madlife setting up around this Baron. And here comes the Void Rush for Baron time.
And are they actually just going to start this?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I mean, with Sivir all the way down in the bot lane, the damage is certainly
they
not as TP. Much.
They have TP. Sivir's not there. They just definitely do it.
Yep, absolutely. We'll see if Maokai can do anything with Sign. CJ actually turning around. They're a little bit scared.
Aww.
Oh, they saw Sivir coming over. I don't know. They might have been able to finish it, but
Oku didn't even have.
Sorry,
Oku didn't even have ults.
Yeah, that's what I was kind of confused about.
They do want to run a more pick or burst style, so getting all into the Baron pit could be.
I mean, if you think about the CJ comp, like, do they vitally need Baron right now? No, not really.
No, they can still siege without it. That's very true.
So why take the risk? Yeah, smart move to back off there.
Oh, we may be going for it again.
I think so. Well, they take the turret, and now they've got a lot of nice vision in the top jungle of Najin. Can approach that Baron maybe a little bit more safely. OQ taking the wolves on his way out, but CJ just all over Najin right now. Interesting ward from Najin. That's not going to be one that CJ finds anytime soon.
No. It's the secret ward. Sometimes you got to put those weird wards in weird places. Actually, they delayed a recall onto Duke.
Wow.
That's just annoying. Yeah. Watch setting up for a flank. This is actually good. It's very, very good.
Teleport coming in. Nice ult by Eve. She matches back out. Tippers comes down. Space in a lot of trouble. Your tries to cleanse. Gets killed anyway. Duke trying to back off now as well. Nice equalizer comes down. Can CJ turn this one around? I don't think so. Double kill for OQ coming in now. Shy in a little bit of trouble. He's tanky, but they need more than that right now. And Zonius, there we go. Goon with the kill. And now OQ on the run. Ambition wants to take him out.
Oh,
can he do it? Ambition
shield.
Gets the kill in the end, but he'll be taken out eventually.
Oh,
wow. There's the ace.
That was a great setup from Najin, honestly. They did not expect Watch to be able to get into position behind them. So the flank on these very squishy carries means that finally Najin can approach them without getting poked out or bursted first, and they cause a lot of commotion, and that gets them a pretty nice team fight win. You can see Ambition's face after that. Wasn't too pleased with it. But that's what happens when you don't ward your flanks, kids.
I guess so.
A great ult by Watch. Yeah, three Watch hitting three people. OQ actually eats the exhaust from Mad Life. So by the time Goon gets there, there's no more exhaust, even though he ults Coco during Zonya's. And Shy does what he can to get a nice equalizer to save his teammate. But once those burst damage dealers are down, there's really nothing else they can do.
Pretty much. Yeah, good fight for Najin. And CJ will need to be a little bit more careful here.
Well, there's still no Aegis against the Ezreal, a choice I always find interesting.
Yep. Why would you get Aegis against AD, Monte Cristo?
Ezreal's AD, right?
Yeah. Sure. Runeblade doesn't change.
Watch anything. Just like, every man for himself, I'm getting Cowl.
Love it, the selfish jungling. CJ going on another warding mission, but Najin has a pretty good idea of where they are. They're going to take the blue buff, though. Not the biggest deal.
See Goon playing the long game here.
Yep.
Wanting to come through, but there's so many CJ wards now.
Oh, Flash Tibber is really, really nice. Mad Life in a little bit of trouble. True Shot Barrage in the middle, but is it
Holy
enough damage?
Holy cow, Space? That equalizer.
No kidding. Yeah, Space doing a lot of damage here. Finally gets taken out by Goon, but Coco untouched in this fight so far. Mad Life has to stay on the outside. They're going to trade fairly evenly. Najin getting a bit of an edge, but CJ chasing. That's a lot of damage coming from Shy. And Duke comes back in to sacrifice his life for his team. Coco, though, wants the kill onto OQ, and he's going to get it. A little bit of a close call there, but Coco comes out ahead.
Well, you just can't walk into the choke. Even though they managed to get on top of Space, they used so much crowd control to do it because Space just built QSS as his third item, as I thought he might.
Yeah.
And so we had the Maokai going very, very deep, but Shy just cut off the rest of the team with the equalizer on the ramp. And Coco was just absolutely free dealing damage that entire team fight. So they chase him off, get four kills, and grab the dragon. Take a look at this. I mean, they try and catch Space, but Space just uses the QSS and flashes, and no one can get through that choke point right now. Goon is not going anywhere. Shy Zonya's with the Flame Spitter right as the equalizer was going down.
That's a Shy
played that
right there.
Beautifully
yeah.
to maximize the amount of time that Coco would have to just be unharmed on the outside.
And Duke thinks he can sacrifice his life for OQ there, but Coco just arcane shifts over the top.
Boop.
Should be fine. There we go.
It's the Ludensbrock, too.
Oh, yeah.
It's always satisfying when you get the Ludensbrock.
Feels good, man. Oh, Coco going to grab that blue buff. He's got an extra, needlessly large rod now as well, too, so the damage continues to mount for CJ. Oh, trying to catch Watch. Nice Q from Mad Life. Wow, what a catch. Getting that slow from the Q.
Watch is really misusing his W this game.
Yeah, he tried to use it to get away again and then got hit with the slow.
It's time to hide in the pit and maybe do the Baron. Ward is there. They should see that ward.
This is still a dangerous Baron for CJ. Cure has Tibbers. They're going to try to come in.
Here
Duke
comes
has
Duke.
Out of ultimate. Zoning equalizer. Pierre comes in to try to do something. Goon. Coco's just Zonya's that death mark. Goon gets exhausted immediately. Mad Life low. But Goon can't even get that kill. Oh, actually. Oh, no, he doesn't. No, CJ just turns. There goes Pure. Shy taking that one out. Coco continuing to poke people to death. Ambition with another kill. Now they'll just casually turn and finish Baron. A double kill for Ambition at the end of that one.
Nice try, but again, a 4v5 coming into the pit. You're dealing with so much damage, and Coco and Mad Life really tag-teamed on the Zonias at the exhaust to make sure that Goong did absolutely nothing.
Yeah. A really good game so far from Ambition. 8-4 and 10 on that Rek'Sai.
Yeah, there were some hiccups.
Yeah, but he's making it count in the team fights at least.
Poop.
I don't
that's
know
right. That's,
that's what
yeah, it is. That's the term you use for the Ludens, even though there wasn't a Ludens right there.
That's what people say when they get hit by a rune glaive, Trusha Barrage.
Well, space goes down in the back of the pit, but again, Coco is just sitting there doing boatloads of damage in the end.
Yep.
Duke goes on a Mad Life killing mission, but that is unsuccessful. Yeah, I mean, Ludens, yeah, it's a boop. You know, it's I said it was a satisfying to get the Ludens proc. It's satisfying because you know it does damage. It's certainly not satisfying when you look at it because it kind of just like spits some purple drops.
Yeah. Yeah, I think they really need to change the animation for Ludens because it just doesn't look very cool at all.
It's the Prince Purple Rain item.
I guess so. Nice spell shield from OQ to avoid the damage from that Trusha Barrage. Uh-oh, Goong.
Goong's been
There's
found.
A ward. He's going to try to get away here. Ambition chasing.
Ooh, he had to use his Ghost Blade and his Blade actives there.
Both blades.
Too many blades.
Too many blades. Classic League of Legends problem. Oh, he's back.
Flight wards are great.
He's like, there's no
Look
ward
at the,
this
They
rush.
Have two pink wards behind them for Evelynn.
Oh, well, Tibbert's tried to engage space in a little bit of trouble. Gets a cleanse. Gets taken out, though. Goong, very, very low. Coco doing tons of damage. Space, still the only victim. He's been dying a lot, but CJ's been able to clean up. They took out Goong. Shy trying to dodge watch. Oh, a double kill for Coco during all that.
I mean, it doesn't matter how many times Space dies.
Not really. And watch a little bit of trouble. There we go. Triple kill for Coco.
I mean, they try it all in on Space every time. He takes.
Oh, wow. Better back to Fountain. Yeah,
he was
yeah.
like, well.
Gotta go back there.
Time to go.
I didn't go very far to begin with, at least. And there goes the inhibitor turret. There goes the inhibitor. Shy just teleporting right back into the action. Don't know if he really needed to, but why not? Well.
But yeah, they can keep killing Space, but Space is actually playing this well. He's using his QSS and then absorbing all of the cooldowns.
Yeah, he's just
And then they
there.
Try to turn on Coco Zonias, and then he's back. He just ends the fight at 50% to full HP every time.
Well, all Space has to do is just walk up, buckshot, ultimate, and that's it. His job is done in the team fight.
Yep.
Oh, okay. Got a few at the end.
Uh-oh. Here comes Goong. He's hunting Ezreals. There are no Ezreals.
Nope.
Ezreal has empowered recall. You cannot catch him that quickly.
Yep. Thornmail onto Ambition now, as we talked about earlier. Things are getting harder and harder. Well, what do you do? CJ looking to kind of steamroll to victory at this point.
Yep, just going to head to the top side now, take out remaining inhibitors. They don't have Baron buff anymore, so I guess Najin has their final chance right here. They also don't have flank wards for the first time.
It could be a bit dangerous, but oh, Trusha Barrage takes a big chunk out of OQ, and that's going to cost them an inhibitor turret at least. Probably just the inhibitor, too. Yep. They will get it. OQ pops that ultimate. They want to go in on this one. Watch gets a nice ult as well, but oh man. Equalizer comes down, and that gives CJ a really nice position to approach this fight. Duke already chunked down after being so tanky. Watch is taken out by Coco. Rommel catches him. Another double kill for Coco. Huge game. Zonias to avoid the death.
Goong wants a kill. There's the death mark. Goodbye before the exhaust can come down.
Oh, but Space wants a bit of revenge. Goong's killed him too many times this game. Oh, he's going to get away anyway, though. I guess CJ can't quite end it yet. They
no.
finally took out Coco.
They got the Coco.
Yep, he's only 11-4-11. And the double-double on that Ezreal. Someday people will realize that it's just good to ban Ezreal right now.
Or have a more concrete plan on how to deal with him, because...
Well, until you do, just ban the Ezreal.
Oh, the baits that are not going to work, because there is a ward.
Oh, well. They can do this
might be bad. They are all at 50% HP.
Tibbers is not up, though, so Pure has to get in range for a W. They're going to catch Ambition. Space is going to be okay, though. Ambition is actually going to be okay as well. Wow. I think they can give up that dragon. Yeah.
Only the first one of the game. Watch back defending the base. A little bit greedy from CJ. They tried to bait it, but there was already a ward that they were a little bit late to remove from the game. Shy has been amazing this game, by the way. I just keep watching Shy in these team fights, and he just is peeling for his carries just with the damage from Rumble extremely well.
Well, it looked like that last fight. You know, Najin wanted to go in, and Equalizer came down and basically just split off the team from the rest of Najin.
And he was also standing on top of both Coco and Space with Flame Spitter on. He was just playing defense, basically. You had to get past him. So
works well. Funny thing is, Ambition had his Sweeping Lens up during that last dragon. He could have just swept it. Wah, wah. Ruby Sidestone now. Gotta get those flank wards down. Meanwhile, Void Staff picked up for Coco. Wasn't doing enough damage yet. Gonna be able to cut through Duke very quickly. Oh, nice arcane shift. Noob.
You say that to Coco, who's at 11-4 and 11 Ezreal.
Yeah, but
professional game.
He couldn't arcane shift over that wall, so.
You must be better.
Deserves the criticism.
All right.
Are they going to try to engage as well? CJ's cutting back. Gets caught with Timbers, though. Mad Life in the back line, though. The tank's doing what they need to do in space. For once, not quite dead yet. Zonia's for Shy, again, creating that Flame Spitter wall. Mad Life gets caught, though, with another Sun. OQ doing a lot of damage. Najin turning this one around a bit.
Yes, but what are they going to lose? I mean, there wasn't a lot of super minions there yet, but CJ may just be happy. Oh, they're not going to go for anything. Just go back off.
Yeah.
Too many home guard enchantments making them scared. It's a good ult by Pure. Pure's actually had some pretty good ults this game, but with the amount of stasis and PL, you can see again there, Space using his QSS and Shy turning this around. Gets the defensive equalizer just so that Space and Coco have some room to poke, but Najin is able to disengage pretty quickly and then take out Mad Life.
Yeah, Pure did a great job in that fight. Built up his stun again so he could get another multi-man stun with the W towards the end. Led to Mad Life being picked off.
Uh-oh. Najin was about to get a second turret this game.
No way.
40 minutes in.
Baron's
Najin
up as well, too.
Completely stalled out with this split push. I mean, it was a risky composition.
Yeah.
It could have come up big, it's true. And they tried to get the Zed fed. If the Zed got fed, Goong absolutely could have just destroyed this game and we could have seen something very one-sided in the opposite direction, but that's a lot of eggs to put in the Goong basket.
And now you've got six-item Runeglaive Ezreal, so good luck. Well, CJ just content to bait this Baron now. Or maybe take it, who knows? Yeah, just take it. Najin coming in, though. A lot of damage onto the Nexus turrets right now, too, coming in from CJ.
All CJ has to do is just sit here and stall.
Yeah. They're so tanky. Well, Watch comes in. They're going to try to make something happen. Nice knockup from Ambition, keeping them from getting it too far. Whoa, that's a lot of AoE, though. Exhaust onto Goong, trying to get a kill here. Duke very low, barely dodges that Mystic shot.
Wow, Duke.
Amazingly, nobody died there.
The Summoner heal actually saved Duke to get him out of range.
Yeah.
Of that last Mystic shot, CJ can't quite take the Baron, but Najin actually hanging in there. Here comes Void Rush and TP.
Uh-oh. Oh, they're going to go after Goong here. Whoa.
What? Space.
All right. Space just decided to die, apparently. Watch is right there, though. Ambition going really deep. Gets a knock up onto Goong. Where's the follow-up, though? They need Coco to come up big here. He does. He gets a kill onto OQ. Double kill. Another one for Coco. He didn't have enough, apparently, yet. Make it a triple, his second of the game so far. Man, OQ's having a huge game. Goong, the true ninja, slips out unseen.
He's like, screw this, guys. There was a celebratory barrage.
Well, he thought he could maybe catch Goong with a recall. He kind of tried to estimate it there, I guess.
Last super minion in
that
the base.
Do it.
Well, I don't know if CJ's actually going to go for the win right here. Goong has GA, so they should back out. The safe way to play this is back out, go for the Baron.
Yep.
Don't chance
Baron
it.
Now. Yeah. More wards. Wards everywhere and taking out some of their opponent's wards as well. Coco kind of low. Duke can be annoying.
Can he?
I don't know. I mean, Coco's very vulnerable against Goong right now.
Well,
I guess he's got his Zonias though, so he's a little bit less vulnerable.
Yeah, well, he might be able just to bait Goog into this.
We'll see. Righteous Glory used. CJ not phased. They're going to keep going for that Baron. And no jungler. Here comes Space. He's back just in time. And there's CJ with the Baron on all five members of the team. Now they can recall. Ooh. Trishot Barrage will clear out some of these minions. May not save the turret, though.
Yep, should actually with the next blue minion wave coming in. And Space zipping over there on his home guard boots. There is an Aegis onto Ambition. I'm not really sure why.
I mean,
it'll be useful once it's a Locket, but it's not really helpful at the moment.
I think Locket is what you're going for here.
Yeah, Locket is definitely helpful again to survive against Zed.
Either that or Banner of Command.
Ooh, sexy.
Yeah.
If it was a Banner, that would also be good, because Najin doesn't have... I mean, they have decent ways, actually. They have Boomerang Blade and they have Razor Shuriken, so they may be able to clear it.
That's true. I suppose the 80 damage is enough where the Banner of Command minions aren't too strong. Well, another dragon's up. Looks like CJ is going to get their fourth without any issues. They will. And so now on that fifth dragon bubble as well, they've got the Baron. They're going to move in to try to take this bottom inhibitor.
Yep, just stack up. They have a big wave of minions, but they don't have any actual champions there that can deal damage to the turret yet. But
don't need it, I guess.
Najin doesn't have any defense right now either, so that's going to go in favor of the Baron minions.
Yeah.
All they have to do is get a couple more auto attacks, and that's going to fall.
Well, Najin really wants to rush in and flank this.
Well, finally, CJ decided to put up some more flank wards. They have pink wards at both positions where Evelynn could flank. Duke has a ward way in the back, but he's going to be running for a very long time. He wants to make that teleport play, but you might as well try. Might as well try soon. Well, he's going to try now.
Get there quick with home guards. Oh, they're going to engage as well, too. Three-man Tibbers. Man, Pure is good. Space just cleanses, though. Moves out. There's the ultimate coming through. Watch trying to do as much damage as he can. Goom tries to get in the back lines. Manages to kill Space. And Najin actually might be able to take this fight. Ambition a lot of trouble, too. Double kill for OQ. Oh, boy. Space gets a kill himself, too. But Najin takes the fight off a triple kill from OQ. They are still alive. What a bloodbath. And that three-man stun from Pure with that Tibbers. Beautiful, beautiful Annie play.
I mean, that was a great flank from Duke, too. He just went for it, even though it was so far away. But the coordination that Najin had on that engage, where Duke, even though he was coming from so far, was still able to get into that fight at the right time because Watch and Pure hit the first two couple of AoE CC abilities.
Now, what can they get out of this? That's the question.
I mean, maybe an inhibitor.
Maybe. I don't think so. Well, maybe.
I mean, they can't win the game right now, which is unfortunate because they have to defend against the super minions, and pushing into the supers is quite difficult and time consuming.
They can get the inhibitor, though. That's for sure. Meanwhile, Goon just staying at home defending the Nexus turret, so they will get that mid inhibitor, and that'll take some of the pressure off. Wow. Nice little comeback from Najin there.
I mean, and if you're CJ, you definitely think you're safe from that flank.
Oh, yeah.
You have a pink ward behind you. You know there are no pink wards in front of that one, and you have a pink ward on the side, too. There's no way you think that Maokai is going to get all over you, but Duke did a great job. And look at the engage, too. Space a little bit too far forward, and then great stun onto all the carries. And here comes Duke, right onto Coco, forces the Zonias. The QSSL is already down, so Goong is able to get into the back line and get the death mark pop onto Space, and OQ just gets a bunch of free autos on the front line. That was very well-coordinated engage by Najin. They've really come alive in this late game.
If Najin wins this game, though, I want that MVP to go to Pure.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
His Annie play has been so good this game. And this series, you know, we thought it'd be close, but this is really close. What a bloodbath, too. Over 50 kills in this game. This is now our highest kill game of the season, actually. Our previous was 44.
Yeah, these teams both love to fight, especially CJ. They usually have a lot of kills in their games. CJ and KT and Ku way up there in terms of kills in games.
55 kills at 47 minutes. It's my kind of game.
So GA now onto Space. Never again. Just got rid of his QSS. He doesn't even care anymore. So I got resist now.
It's like I've died seven times this game. I'm tired of it.
Well, he just figures if he dies, maybe by the time he comes back up, there won't be any more crowd control to continuously lock him down.
Could be. Although that means more crowd control is going to be focused on Coco now.
Well, he's got Zonya, so he's okay.
Space. Oh, he's got Zonya's too. Mad Life with the frozen heart.
Well, it's a very good item this game. Just go for armor. He got a very early Glacial Shroud. You can see Mad Life also has the Crucible, so they have the AGA and the Crucible now for space. Wow, Shy has Luden's Echo. What the? What?
Oh, wow.
Well, I don't know about getting that before Void Staff. That is weird.
Or Rylai's.
Yeah.
I mean, you have more movement, but. Interesting. Well, Najin pushing down the mid lane. CJ on the defensive for the first time in a long time in this game.
If CJ loses this game, it's going to be ridiculous. Najin will be truly heroic for trying, for figuring out ways to get around GAs and Zonyas and actually execute the necessary flanks to take out their backline against the massive amount of peel that CJ has.
Interestingly enough, Dragon and Baron coming up at nearly the same time. That could present a bit of an issue for Najin, since CJ has got four dragons right now.
Yeah, that's probably going to push it over the brink, honestly, because CJ will have no problem threatening both objectives at the same time with their poke and the fact that Space can just sit there and auto the dragon by himself.
They need more wards in this bottom jungle, though. They're
also
try this dragon.
Goon's GA is not up yet. That
is a pretty
big factor. It'll be up shortly, but I'm not sure it's going to be up. It's not going to be up in time for the start of the dragon, at least.
I mean, we're at the point in the game, too, where these objectives are just going to melt so fast. Are they going to, like, threaten the back door here, or front door, I guess, if they go for the dragon? Najin could just rush. They're going to. They're actually going to. Wow, they're just rushing the Nexus. Recall's coming in from CJ. They'll get back there in plenty of time. It's still kind of a matter of, are they going
Coco's
to...
Coco's not there. He's about 8 seconds behind.
He canceled his recall. Goom slowed down a bit.
It's a good call from CJ. The inhibitors are up on the enemy side of the map. Yours is still down. Ambition also is in a position where he could have flanked or he could have just gone straight back to the dragon.
Yep.
And they have wards on it, so doing okay.
Mad Life may be able to find an ult here. GA back up for Goon again. No. Najin needs this dragon. They need it.
Yeah, that's a great way to deny it, though. They're using the strength of what they have right now. And here comes the fight. You could see that everybody's
teleport coming in. CJ pulling back. This equalizer could be very, very good for CJ. There we go. Space and Coco with plenty of space to fight. Goon gets the kill onto Mad Life, but now CJ on the chase. OQ running a little bit. Gets poked very hard by Coco. Deathmark coming in onto Coco. Just zones it immediately. Goon in a lot of trouble. Space with the kill onto OQ. Goon GA pops, but that is going to be a dead Zed. Double kill for Space.
And the setup was so good
CJ.
You could see how they were just tightly kiting from that choke point.
They pulled the
daring them
choke
to go through. And again, Shy hits a very good equalizer in that game to provide the necessary zone. Yeah, there's a lot of minion waves, but there are some long, long death timers.
Yeah, only Pure and Watch able to try to defend the Nexus, and it is not going to be enough. Watch coming in onto Ambition tries to get the kill, but that's not going to help. Not going to do anything there. Pure has had a great game, but that is going to be about it. Coco trying to get the kill onto Pure here. Another stun. That is it. GG, and CJ wins a pretty nail-biting game one at 51 minutes. 57 kills in the game. 59 kills, actually. Our highest kill game so far this season.
You're crazy. Awesome. I'm actually impressed that Najin managed to just keep on fighting and keep on getting fights that were going their way, even when CJ took some decent precautions.
14-5-15 is the final score for Coco. Absolutely slaughtering on that Ezreal. Wow. Mad Life 3-4-26. Ambition 8-5-23. Some pretty insane. Oh, time to pull it together if you're Najin as we go into picks and bans for game number two between these two teams. And of course, visit ogn.azubi.tv to vote for your favorite super plays. A lot of good ones coming out tonight. Shen ban from Najin against CJ.
Okay.
So that happened.
I mean, whatever.
I don't know if that was the best use of a ban.
They banned Callista Gragas and Rise in Game 1. Of course, they have more freedom in terms of those bans. And Shai's performance has been okay on Shen, but I wouldn't say it's out of this world.
Ban-worthy? Yeah, probably not. Yeah. Oh, it's the second ban going to be from Najin. The Rise. Rise, interestingly, banned out on the blue side. Huh.
Well, I think Najin had a rough time. But when they played earlier against KT, they were actually baited into Rise 2 games in a row, and KT kind of stomped them and shut Duke down early.
Duke's Rise has not been...
Oh, wait, his Rise is super good. We know that historically, but...
It feels like you can really hurt it.
Well,
time,
if you get
though.
Camped, yes.
If you have a plan for the Rise, you can handle it.
But what is CJ going to do? Because they don't have the two mid lane bans, or picks this time, bans rather, against Victor and Azir. And you have to assume, Najin has had no problems first picking Victor on blue side. TF. Probably smart.
Okay. And that final ban from CJ. What do they not want to let Najin first pick?
I would say Victor. Victor.
Oh, okay.
You're on red side. You can just take the Ezreal right now and then have space play it if you don't like what Goong's going to play. And force Goong onto Azir, something that, honestly, Goong has not been as much of an ASAT as Coco, but it's going to be an Evelynn ban.
Huh. So not wanting to deal with that. So basically saying, all right, well, if you take something other than Rek'Sai, then we get a Rek'Sai that will, I guess, not really be any more better ahead because Evelynn's not in the game to take advantage of.
Right. Well, I mean, Rek'Sai is still going to be a very strong early game pick here regardless.
Yeah.
The Echo is still available too.
Rumble, dude.
I think you take the Rek'Sai and you take Victor here. Hmm. Unless you have a plan to deal with Goong's Victor, which could very well be just pick Ezreal again.
Or the Ezreal. I mean, I like the Rumble here. Shai had a great game on Rumble. Why change it? Well, Maokai wouldn't be bad either.
I'd be afraid of Duke's Fizz, so I would not, in fact, go for the Maokai. Just handle it like you did before. Shai also has a very poor historical record on Hecarim, so I am relieved he is not picking that champion.
That was a bit scary for a moment. A Victor insta-locked for Goong. We'll see what Watch decides to pick up for Najin. And their second round here. Still need a jungler. Jungle options are going to be interesting for Watch. Without Eve, they really have kind of...
Probably play Echo.
Pigeonholed him a little bit, yeah. Could be Echo, but how would that go for Watch, I wonder?
Yeah, it's fine. I think it's fine.
I mean, it's a good pick right now, but I just don't know how good Watch is on it.
Well, he's a-thinking right now. They're going to take the Annie again for Pure.
Oh, Pure had a fantastic game on Annie in game number one, so...
So basically, they're just building the same composition they had last game, except this time they have the Victor. And Victor probably would have done a lot better in those teamfights, by the way, than that Zed did in the late game. In fact, Najin may have been able to win that game had they had Victor instead of the Zed.
Agreed. Probably not going to be the Rengar. But we'll see.
I mean, I assume Najin's going to take the Maokai again because they did do very well on those engages. The question is, what is Watch going to play because he has to change his champion too.
Yeah. Well, the Graves worked out very, very well last game. They could just grab Ezreal again, honestly, but might decide to go for that Azir.
I don't know why they would have to take the Azir right in this round of the draft.
Yeah, well,
we haven't seen Jace since the Jace buffs. Or changes. It's not really a buff.
Yeah.
I mean, it is in the late game, but it takes you sort of longer to get to a point where it is a buff.
Well, Coco's Azir has been some of the most amazing Azir play we've seen.
Some of the
in
most
Korea.
Azir play.
It's the Azirist Azir.
He is the Azirist Azir.
Nobody Azirs like Coco's Azirs.
I agree with you. I think he's been wonderful on that champion.
Yeah. Interesting that they'd stick with the Graves, though.
I think they just see the lane matchup, and they're very comfortable in using the Graves to prevent OQ from getting a big lead. Watch could default to Lee Sin, as he is wont to do, and Duke could play Riven. We've seen a lot of Riven versus Rumble so far this season on Champions, and some players, like Smeb, have been able to do very well in that matchup. Kuve also. Aww.
Wah, wah. Oh, well, Maokai's still a very strong pick, of course. And that's what they'll go with, along with the Lee Sin for Watch. And so what is the support pick going to be? Is it just going to be the Braum again? Mad Life played pretty well on that Braum last game. Thresh also a good option as well.
Thresh is more vulnerable to any all-ins early. Also, Alistar falling way down the draft. Alistar definitely a viable choice in this lane. You have that ability to break the crowd control, and it is historically one of Mad Life's best champions. Janna may be a safer option for late game peeling from a Maokai flank. I don't know. I think you just go for the Alistar here.
Zyra, man, we haven't seen Zyra in a long time.
Mad Life going through every single support in League of Legends slowly.
Including Zac, apparently. It's going to be, the Leona would be an interesting pick.
That would be great for their engage. They lack primary engage right now. They don't really need it, but it will be the Braum.
Oh, well. Braum was good for Mad Life last game. Would have been fun to see the Leona, of course, but I think it looks like a pretty solid lineup for CJ.
I think I would have taken the Alistar here. There must be something they like about the Braum into the Sivir. Of course, you can just use Unbreakable to block a Boomerang Blade and get the better end of a trade, but I think the Alistar, even though he provides more immediate engage for this CJ Entis team, which they don't have that much of this time around, pretty much just the Equalizer, but again, CJ is that team that likes to build around Coco engaging with Azir.
Yeah.
And the burst damage, the crazy thing about this is if you hit a good Emperor's Divide, you can line people up for a spectacular collateral damage.
Yeah.
Or even a Braum ultimate, that Glacial Fissure. You get everybody moved into position for that, and Equalizer. Just a lot of line skill shots here from CJ Entis.
Yeah, and Coco has really come through for CJ in the past with these engages on Azir, and no real reason to believe that he's not going to be able to do it again.
Oh, we see so many bans against Coco's Azir that now getting him to see him play it is actually a rare treat. He's got a good matchup in the lane against the Victor. Should be able to poke Goom out early.
True enough. Well, if CJ can 2-0 this, that would be a huge thing for them going into the playoffs. It would also be huge in a negative sense for Najin as well. A lot on the line as we go into Najin versus CJ game number two. It's go time. All right, welcome to Summoner's Rift once again. And the fans out in force, crazy game one. I loved it, man. 59 kills. That was a fun game. There's just no pleasing you with that type of game.
That's not true. I thought it was fun, too.
Okay, good. You can be honest with your feelings. You don't need to hold it. You don't need to bottle up that love of kill-heavy games inside. You know, you're secretly jealous of the LPL casters.
Nope.
Well, a little bit of an early invade from CJ to get some warding down, potentially. A little bit awkward, though. Can't really get any of those wards in. They get one into the red buff pit, at least.
Yeah, just trying to get some early identification about where this is going. They're also trying to disrupt the saplings in the raptor area. Coco's still on a bit of a mission right there, but they see his sapling disruption activities. And they're stacking four people at that brush to make sure that CJ really has to commit if they want to take those out.
Yeah, and they don't want to commit, and it's probably not worth it anyway.
What is with the pool party Rex? Oh, God, her jaw is crazy.
Yeah, I know. Pretty creepy, huh?
How do you chew with that? You just swallow things whole, I guess.
You chew very small things on each side of your mouth, I guess. Or you eat plankton.
Ooh, Shy actually going to get the Gromp first, and Duke just taking the little raptors before heading into lane. So.
Yep. So pretty quick level two for both of our top laners. Watch is going to start at his own red. And we've got standard lanes.
Oh boy, well, CJ probably going to be pretty happy with this considering they keep picking the Graves into it.
Yeah, no kidding. Well, Space again, you know, can just kind of walk up and auto with that spell shield not taken by Oku yet.
Yep. Good, just getting that down, slowing down OQ while he's at it. Stun loaded up for Pure, though. I have to be slightly cautious.
Yeah, probably has a W at level one. Certainly has a W
yes,
at level
definitely
one.
Does.
Yeah.
And then we're into Poke City in the mid lane.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
The meta of poking mid laners.
Not sure it's going to get much better in the next patch.
Well, at least there's no Ziggs. I think Ziggs will come back in 5.13.
Maybe.
Oh, boy.
Maybe. So he's definitely, with all his spell spam, a prime Liandry's candidate.
Makes sense. Well, it's going to be a pretty quiet early game, as most often are.
Yeah, especially since Shy is playing so conservatively. You can see he's just sitting right there at his turret, giving Watch no chance to pull off an early gank. Duke just goes back immediately. He didn't have to burn his teleport like Shy did, so he wants that second Doran's ring. Watch can make some plays up here. Duke could get rolling. And, I mean, Graves damage probably not going to be too severe in the late game for him because he'll be able to lock Graves down fairly quickly.
Yeah.
So he can build a lot of MR here and probably do okay.
Yeah, the burst coming in onto Gung and OQ from the collateral damage from things like that is kind of the primary concern for Najin, I would imagine, in a team fight.
Okay, so it's like Ambition is starting to lurk around the top side. Watch nowhere near. And Gung playing over to the bottom side of the map. Right well, now where his ward is.
A lot of wards up in the top, though, for Najin, so I don't think Duke is going to be too worried.
No, it's mostly just about playing around the counter gank right now onto the Rumble more than anything else.
Yeah.
But Watch is not even remotely set up, and he will be seen on this ward by Duke right as the Trinket ward expires, so...
Oh, then let's Watch do a bit of counter jungling.
From both sides, really.
Yeah. Why not?
So I like what we're seeing Ambition do, just trying to make sure Shy has the perfect coverage while he pushes up. We see him just jungling very intelligently around that top side in conjunction with Shy's wave pressure at the moment. And so he'll be able to take that out and Watch just playing around the vision. So both junglers doing everything they should be right now, playing as conservatively as they can around where their laners are.
Much.
This could be a bit of a gank onto Goon. Coco has been poked pretty severely. But Goon playing
yeah,
pretty far
Ambition
up.
Coming in from behind. There's a stun though and Ambition. It's going to hit. Goon taking a little bit of damage. Q misses. Yeah, Goon very ready with that gravity field.
Yeah, Madlife there on his own too. Just following Pure's Annie up the lane just in case they have to both get into a scrap. Doesn't end up resulting in that.
A little bit of aggression in the bot lane. But overall, very passive early start. Both teams playing it out very safely. Although, nice little CS lead for Coco.
Madlife throwing chairs.
Oh,
ghost
yeah.
chairs.
Ghost chairs. What? Chairs advantage. It's more like Thor chairs, right? Because they come back.
They don't come back. They just go out into the void.
Well, we don't know if they don't come
he
back.
He holds on to his original chair while the entire time while he's doing it.
I don't know.
They're ghost chairs.
I have no explanation for this then.
It's a magic chair that shoots energy chairs at things. See?
Sounds about right. Stun on a mad life. As Ambition clears out some of the wards in River, you can see mad life getting a bit aggressive just to give Ambition the time for that.
I guess the Korean casters are talking about Krugs.
Krugs are hilarious, man.
Truly.
What are those dudes? Just like little rock things, man.
Little rock things, man.
They're little rock things, man. Watch is like, where are the rock things? Oh, no, my ward.
There are a lot of animated rocks in the jungle.
It's true. There's a lot of
Golems,
animated
Krugs.
Inanimate objects in League in general. Maokai is a tree. Malphite is basically a rock. Yep. Oh.
Okay. This has been a very quiet game compared to our last one.
I know. I was so excited about the series, and now we've got this. Come on.
Well, OQ's actually winning lane this time, which is interesting. He's up in CS, so they've adapted just a little bit to what was going on in this same lane matchup that CJ found pretty, I suppose, mildly preferable in the last game.
Yep, pretty much. Well, T-Grave Braum is a pretty cool skin.
It is. I agree with you. Is it your favorite Braum skin, Doa?
Yeah, I think so, probably. It's okay, but I don't play a lot of Braum.
You're not a Braumer?
Not so much. He's fun, but lately it's been a lot of Annie and Lulu again.
Back to
the basics.
The girls of the bottom lane.
Well, aside from Janna, Soraka, Sona, Leona, yeah. Basically.
All supports are female, except for Braum.
And Bard. Well, we don't know what Bard is, technically.
Yeah, Jesus.
Well, they call him a he, so if they call Rek'Sai a she, I feel like Riot's denotating gender through their lore that way.
I suppose, but...
Tahm Kench?
Maybe a support, maybe a top laner, who knows?
Well, according to Pikaboo, he thinks he's more of a top laner than a support.
We can look forward to the jungler coming up there and then ganking the mid lane together with the top.
Yep.
Exciting times.
I'd enjoy it.
You enjoy licking people in the top lane?
Consuming their flesh. Well,
he doesn't actually eat anything. Have you noticed that?
Yeah, it is a little bit weird.
What's up with that, Tahm Kench? You just talk about eating things, but you don't actually ever eat anything. You just vomited it out.
It's not healthy either.
No, that's not good for you, Tahm Kench.
You don't need to lose weight that badly, Tahm Kench. There's diet and exercise that can help you. Don't take the dark route, man.
I agree.
Yeah. What is this teaching our young, impressionable gamers, Riot? Come on.
Well, I mean, Riot already has a guy who drinks copious, like, barrels full of alcohol throughout the game.
Right.
And who slurs his words.
Well.
Apparently that's okay, but smoking a cigar is definitely not.
Yeah, gotta get rid of that thing, man. That'll kill you.
Even though Gragas, the Gragas Esquire skin, I think he's smoking a cigarette.
Yeah, he does have a cigar, doesn't he? A cigarette or something like that. It's one of those, like, long, like, Cruella de Vil cigarettes, you know?
Why was he allowed to... I don't even understand this remotely.
That's a really good point. I hadn't even thought of that. Yeah. There's a Gragas skin that still has a smoke implement.
A smoke implement.
what would you call, like, general, like, you know, if you lump, like,
tobacco?
Cigars, cigarettes, a tobacco product?
Yes, there you go.
That sounds so boring.
I think tobacco product is better than smoke implement.
Smoke
which could be, you know,
so
an incense sensor or something like that. I don't know. Maokai's brazier that he stupidly wears on the back of his head.
Okay, all right, you got me there. The Maokai brazier pushed it over the top for me. Well, all right.
We almost got something exciting to happen in this game, Doa.
Oh, boy. We need to pause right now. That's what we need. What's Victor doing? He steps on this. He raises up his arms. He's like, he's like, it's wet. Maybe he's getting electrocuted while he's doing that because of all his mechanical electronic stuff.
I think he just gets hyped over how evil he's being, destroying,
like, yeah,
Rek'Sai's tunnel. Take that.
All the, like, tunnel destroying animations make no sense.
Did they just, like, take the Dominion channeling animations? I think they did,
yeah.
Which would make a lot more sense for Victor to do that.
Yeah. He just loves wrecking tunnels. What a jerk. Well. Yeah, so. Huh.
You know, I wonder how long it took for those animations, those Dominion animations, to be used more for clearing Rek'Sai tunnels than for people actually playing Dominion.
Huh.
I think actually that statistic has already been passed,
even though
Dominion has been out for years.
You're probably right. I think people have cleared a lot more Rek'Sai tunnels
than channeled at Dominion points.
It's probably true. Man, every lane is a top lane this game.
Every lane is a top lane.
Every lane a top lane.
Doa's worst nightmare.
That's right.
Maybe somebody will go for Dragon right now.
Maybe. Yeah, it looks like CJ wants to. OQ and Pure getting pushed back by Space and Mad Life. Meanwhile, the Dragon looks like it's about to be started by Ambition and Coco.
Space Life.
Space Life. Mad Space. I like that one better.
No, I like Space Life.
Space Life.
Sounds like living in 200 years from now.
I don't know. That's what they thought in like the 1950s, though. We'd be living in space. We'd be like the Jetsons and stuff. Although technically the Jetsons don't live
in
space.
They did not live in space.
But they had the ability to go to space if they wanted to.
That's true. So do you if you have enough money, Noah.
I guess. That's true. I'm no George Jetson, though.
Pretty sure there's some Russian rockets you could take if you're a millionaire. Uh-oh.
Who gets the rockets? Who gets the red buff? Oh, watch. Decides he wants to come back in. That's a bad idea. Knocked up. Will it be first blood? There's the exhaust. They really want this one. And it will be. Mad Life grabs it. Meanwhile, more kills come in. Here we go.
What was Shy doing there? He was just left by himself. He didn't even have any HP at the end. Came and dropped the equalizer. Somehow Annie dies too. Well, that was exciting.
Sure. Oh, kill for Coco.
And he got the red buff.
The red buff was not taken by anyone until right now. Yeah, Ambition finally gets it though. It's like, there, worth it. Amid the fallen bodies of my comrades, I will take this red buff.
They could just go right to Dragon too if they want.
Yeah.
Just do the dragon. Just do it.
Do the dragon.
What?
Do that sounds like
what? Just do the dragon.
It's like a soft drink.
Do
the dragon.
You have the smite. You have people in the bottom lane. I guess they really needed to go back and get that crit cloak.
Need it bad. You need to almost have your Infinity Edge. Well, Coco with a quick Morel and Omicron.
Yeah, maybe if they had waited long enough to get the ambient gold, they could have actually had enough money to complete the Infinity Edge.
Yeah, that's a good point. Will they go for the dragon now, though? I feel like this game, they're like, all right, we overfilled our quota of kills in game number one. We have to dial it back, guys. We're only allowed like 10 more kills total in this series.
Otherwise, it starts cutting into the quota for the next series.
Yeah, and then you have to just like make really boring strategies around it. So why not just play it safe this time? Play it slow.
Hey, Watch really misplayed that red, too. He was just by himself right there. And instead of just backing off, he continued to scrap just a little bit too long.
Oops.
Ambition is here with a red buff. Looking
he
at,
fought
looking
hard
at a
for
dragon.
That red buff. All right, time to take the dragon.
I guess now is the time to take the dragon.
Yep, now is the time to take the dragon.
Goong actually recalling, so they should definitely do the dragon.
And now is the time to take the dragon. Shy, defending his turret. Now is not the time for the dragon. Now is the time for a giant dive in bot lane.
No, they're trying to free space.
Oh.
Space is...
Oh, he's in. He's in a prison of space, not space prison.
That's right. Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Yay.
Time to take the dragon. Oh, Q landed by Watch, though. They're going to try to contest this. Watch coming in. CJ has chosen a difficult time. Braum ult used. Manlife getting very low. Dragon taken by CJ. They get a kill, too. On to Pure. Space grabs one. Oh, Coco getting very low. Has to flash over the wall. Chaos Storm comes back in. They're going to turn around on this one. Ambition on the run now. OQ nearly taken out by Space while Madlife dies almost to the death laser, but then doesn't. That was a, I don't know.
It.
I thought he was going to die. Had to turn that sentence around in a hurry, man. That was
dies almost, but then doesn't.
That was an emergency situation.
Sometimes you just get into a corner while you're casting to find creative ways to get out of it.
See, the thing is when there's a lot going on, you have to kind of predict a little bit so that you can start saying what's going to happen before it happens. And if you're wrong, you end up in situations like that, guys.
Really,
the reality of casting.
It really is an art to be able to begin your sentences in ways that you can get them out, but you can end it either way.
That's right.
And sometimes, like all art, it takes practice, and you end up with that.
Even if you're an expert, you know? Sometimes you just fail hard. It's okay.
That wasn't that bad. You did save it.
That's true. It made logical, grammatical sense, even if it wasn't natural.
Grammatical.
You couldn't have done that one better.
I give up. I'm done. Watch takes a blue buff. Yeah, stuff happens. Pierre wants to get a stun on Ambition. He does. Uh-oh, kicked out by Ambition. Your team has abandoned you.
To the death of Stunlock.
That's right. That was a pretty textbook stun into Lee Sin kick.
Watch got it.
Like, oh.
Watch got his blue buff back.
Ambition's just happy he didn't give up first blood. He tried. He almost did, but nope.
The call of Watches for getting first blooded was stronger.
Yep. Pretty much.
Well, that was a nice attempt at a blue steal, but quickly foiled.
When blue steals go wrong.
Yeah.
Well, Space looking pretty good on this Graves, though. He's got his Infinity Edge. Got his Berserker's Greaves. He's ready to Berserk with those Greaves.
Yeah, you know what's funny about that is Berserkers were famous for wearing no clothing.
Yeah, exactly. They wouldn't wear anything. They needed was a big sword.
And bearskins.
And bearskins.
Yeah, because that's the whole thing, is they were Vikings from a cult of Odin.
Right.
Which Berserk comes from Bearsark, which means bear shirt in Old Norse. And so they would go crazy. They would get themselves into a battle rage and only wear animal skins in combat because they thought that it would give them the spirit of the ferocity of the animal.
Yeah.
And people were so afraid to fight them, too, because they were crazy. Do you really want to fight against a guy who is crazy enough to run into battle naked except for wearing a bit? How do you even beat that?
Probably not. I mean, you just shoot him, I guess. But if you didn't have any implement of ranged combat.
Uh-oh, TP.
Yep, they're coming in there. Wow, Annie's goes down in a pretty big Tibbers. And OQ actually getting a lot of auto attacks in on this fight. Really good positioning there for him. Kills coming in for Goong as well. Ambition very low. OQ with another one here. Watching a lot of trouble. Looks like CJ's going to try to start to turn this one around. Nice zoning by Azir. Victor has to go for a run there. That means away from the fight. Koko coming in. Ember survived. He doesn't catch OQ, but he gets the kill anyway.
And Goong. Here we go. Shy.
Whoa! One more from OQ or from Koko. Do it. Triple kill for Koko. He's starting it again. And now Duke in a lot of trouble. Shy. There's the flash. Looks like they couldn't quite catch him.
Yeah, can't quite pursue it under turret. Koko's positioning, he was in the dragon pit for that entire fight. The start, at least, not the entire fight. Well, I'm messing up too now, though. It's been a long night.
It's been a really long night, man.
It's been a really long night.
Wow,
so,
I don't know what it is.
Yeah, just getting a lot of auto attacks over the walls with the Sand Soldiers quite safely before actually committing fully to the engagement to turn it around once Najin thought that they were on the winning end, but without any more Annie stun or a lot of ultimates. Just take a look at how that went. They bursted Space down, but Space actually flashes out and gets the dash. So he ends up living even though Mad Life dies, but there's so much equalizer damage. And now watch Koko come in, gets on top of Watch immediately on that engage, gets the knockup, and then starts just controlling the choke point. Now he gets a lot of damage onto OQ, gets through, is stunned at the end by that gravity field, but Shy knows, he sees Goong has no mana. So just pretty easy to walk up on Goong there, and Duke still has his flash available, so he's not going to die, and there's no more flashes to follow up.
Yeah, now CJ trading turrets here with Najin. Najin taking the bottom one, CJ's gonna get the top.
I don't know about all these buff invades by Ambition, though. I don't know if this is...
It's ambitious.
It is. It's so risky.
Oh, Mad Life gets a blue buff. Flash ult doesn't hit anybody. Oh, Mad Life.
Well, they did pop the Sivir ult, too.
Yeah, I guess.
Move away from that. Nice reflex from OQ.
I just feel bad.
Do you feel bad, Life?
I feel bad when I see that. Bad Life.
Yeah, so back to Berserkers.
Yeah.
They didn't wear greaves.
These guys were crazy. So
can you look up, Brian, can you please look up the definition of words before you use them? You can just make up words, too. You do that all the time. Like Gromp.
Gromp Greaves. Well, OQ gets slowed down. Are they going to dive this? You bet they are. There's a knockup as well. Mad Life jumps in, helps Space pick up another kill. Everybody gets out just fine.
Also, Greaves were Greek.
Greek Greaves?
They're part of the Greek armor.
Oh, yeah. Now everybody just uses them as a term for any sort of leg armor, though, right?
Yeah. I mean, it's like Harry Potter. You just like take all these old words and you throw them into a no context environment and mash
like
them
wizard.
All together.
Wizard or Voldemort. Nobody knows what Voldemort means anymore. Snape. And, of course, Quidditch. And there goes Dragon number two for CJ. It's two for them so far this game. Well, CJ's looking, whoa, big fight in the mid lane suddenly out of nowhere. Exhaust onto Goon, Madlife wades in the middle of things, but Najin catching a couple members of CJ, but here comes Space to fight the 1v4. I guess. He's like, no, that's a bad idea. I'm running away.
Wow, that was a very surprising bait from Najin, but yeah. I don't really know what Ambition and Madlife were doing
I
there.
I want to see a replay of that. That
trying
was
to get some wards, but they had no vision. There were two pink wards from Najin, so Najin just all sitting in that brush. And considering that CJ has deep wards in both top and bottom jungle, probably should not be face-checking brushes. If you can't see anybody in lane and you can't see anybody in either side of the jungle, a bit sloppy. This is what we've been talking about with Madlife and Ambition, kind of making some questionable plays around vision.
Yeah.
It was better in game one, but this time, some free kills just handed over to Najin. Oh, wow.
Whoa,
Space just wants to go for it.
Yeah. A lot of damage onto OQ, but he can't quite chase him down. Didn't get the ult, though. I feel like it would have been worth it to chase a little bit farther. They had the ward in the tri-brush, but...
He also was up heal, yeah. And he's up a static shiv onto OQ, so maybe might have been able to do a little bit more, I agree.
Could have at least gotten the ultimate anyway. Oh, Space sees Watch there. Oh.
Some smoke for you, Watch.
Yep.
Uh-oh.
But no smoke for Graves. He can give other people smoke, but he can't enjoy it himself.
Now he just has to put down the smoke screen and walk into it.
That's right. Just inhale deeply. Just goes on the smoke screen and goes, oh, there we go. You ever played AP Graves?
The smoke screen.
Get like the big nuke smoke screen. Nobody suspects that in ARAM, man. Man, I cannot talk tonight.
Nobody expects the Runeglaive Gangplank either.
True. Maybe soon they will.
No, probably not with nerfs to the Runeglaive coming.
Runeplank. Gangplank. Oh, several pop. The teleport's going to come in as well, too. How are they going to handle it? Duke goes in, and oh, they're going to kick Space right into the enemy team. He's going to flash over the wall, though. There's a knock-up onto Goon. Nice equalizer from Shy, actually. Duke over the wall onto Space. It's like a 1v1, but Space will win it. And CJ taking this fight. Coco over the wall onto OQ.
Wow.
Nice effort survive for the double kill. Man, Coco's good, and Shy takes out Goon. And that is nearly an ace. Nobody on CJ going down.
Wow, that was such an aggressive move. CJ just got out of there immediately. They saw the teleport instantly on the play that Duke was trying to make with the rest of Najin. Now they're just able to push down onto the inhibitor turret. Probably an overcommitment there from Najin. I don't know if there was as much of an advantage as they thought there would be.
Now, Space has been really good about getting out of sticky situations this game as well, too. And man, they were just so ready for this teleport.
Yeah, and they fall back, and yet they're all grouped up here. Now Space, again, somehow manages to get out of this. He flashes for the second time, even though he does get knocked around. And that was just a perfect equalizer into the choke point. And I understand what Najin was thinking. Now, they had a good opportunity for Chaos Storm, too, but by that time, and first off, or second off, rather, that Azir play by Coco was very impressive. But they thought that they could land that big Chaos Storm on four members, but by the time that they actually got there, Shy had outranged Victor with the equalizer, and his team was on the retreat, and CJ had seen that Victor coming and had broken apart, so that Victor wasn't able to do quite as much damage. Close, though, actually. Very close.
Well, CJ pulling farther and farther ahead in game number two, up five turrets to zero, or five turrets to two right now.
I love how Space just has to go third item QSS in these games because he's just been so heavily targeted. He still manages to somehow escape during some of these fights, and looked like OQ could have been doing a little bit more damage right after Space was kicked next to him.
Well, with what Shy and Coco can do in these team fights, Space, again, just really needs to buckshot, ultimate, get out of there, and any damage he gets to do beyond that is kind of bonus for CJ.
That's true. They have a lot of sustained damage from Coco and Shy as they move forward.
Whoa, OQ.
Whoa, Q.
Whoa, Q. Oh, no, Q. You better go Q.
Go back home.
Yep. Take it slow, Q. Oh, they're going to go for Baron. With poking out the ADC like that, they've got a chance, but they want to bait it instead.
Have some smoke, Cure.
Enjoy your smoke. Oh, that was a Q that did not go into the brush. Watch was aiming that. We could see CJ go on to this. We'll see. Shy's a ways away and has no teleport, though. Ambition, though, coming in. He may want to do something. Coco trying to flank from the side here. Has that Emperor's Divide, and they're going to slow down Duke. There's Equalizer. Emperor's Divide pushes people in. Duke comes in. He's separated from the rest of his team. There's a kill for CJ. Whoa, big gravity field, big chaos storm. But everybody on CJ escapes for now anyway.
Wow, so low. Coco and Ambition are up. Coco and Ambition.
Coco.
They've combined into one carry. Coco. Coco and Ambition barely escaping out of that. That could have easily gone in Najin's favor had either of them died. And they really grouped up against Victor. That is so dangerous to do.
Yeah.
If they hadn't had the locket, they probably would have gone down, especially Ambition.
This Dragon number three now for CJ, just unopposed. And much more one-sided game than we saw in game number one.
I don't know. It was about this one-sided at this point, last game. 5-6K gold ahead.
Feels more one-sided for some reason, though.
Wow. I mean, Najin can still win this if they get the right combo off with Victor. They have much AoE. But Coco, again, showing up big on this Azir, something we've seen from him time and time again. I wonder if we're going to see a replay of that. I think that was a little bit try-hard by CJ. They kind of forced that initiation and nearly got it turned on its head because Pure and Goong just chained their stuns.
I think they really want to get a big lead at this point because they don't want to have to deal with what they dealt with last game.
Yeah, quite possible.
Well, CJ putting the hurt onto Najin now across multiple lanes. Shy pushing top, and everybody else just zoning Baron a little bit.
And there's the tower.
Yep.
Is it time to go for the Baron? They haven't actually cleared out all the wards. There's a ward on the inside and on the outside of the pit, so Najin has some sneaky vision, but no call is just to siege the tier two that Najin is not set up to defend.
Well, they'll just take it. Coco's been doing such an excellent job of poking out critical members of Najin as well, too. The damage onto OQ before the last fight, the damage onto Watch just now. And there are wards there.
Yeah, those are very sneaky wards, by the way. It's unlikely that both of them would get cleared out. That's the second time we've seen that ward on the inside of the pit. Super annoying. There you go. Just going to change that. Now they find it. But they're still not going to find the one on the outside. That is so clever because you're probably not going to try and clear both of those.
Yeah. Well, CJ pulling back into their own jungle for a moment anyway. And again, like, a 2-0 for CJ would be so big for this team. Going into the end of summer season, into Worlds. They really need this. And Najin, summer season is the season where Najin excels. You know, that's the season where they punch their ticket to Worlds every year, it seems. But this might be the first year in a while where we don't see a Najin team at Worlds.
Well, you have to do it in the most spectacular and unlikely way, though,
Doa. It's true. You have to go all the way through the gauntlet from the very bottom.
You have to win three consecutive best of fives in a week to do it.
Yep. Which was against, what was it, CJ, KT, and SKT last year, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Doesn't get much more difficult than that.
Yeah, it was CJ, Blaze, KT, Rose, and SKTK.
Right. They're going to start this Baron.
Ah, yes. The old over-the-wall Baron with Azir.
Yep.
Can't really do that with Graves, though.
Yeah, his range a little bit too short there.
Remember, CJ doesn't have a great way to engage, which is why they're struggling right now, why we saw them force the engage with Coco and Ambition in the last one from the flank. Unless they have the Equalizer there, they don't have a long-range way to CC people and start a fight.
I find it pretty amazing that both Coco and Space have zero deaths right now.
Yes, especially with how hard they've been in the enemy team's front line.
Yeah. Well, especially Space. It's hard to make it 32 minutes into the game as Graves and not die. Oh, Ambition thinks he finds an opportunity here. Ooh, gets very poked in return, though.
Yeah, that is. You're not going to be able to get on a Victor who can get that speed buff from his Q. Simply going to take a lot of damage.
Oh, now they're going to go in trying to stun Coco, but he's able to get out with that cleanse. Equalizer comes down, splits up Najin quite nicely. Bad Life kicked in the back lines. Najin chasing away a member of CJ down the bottom. Oh, Space actually gets away there. Has to burn both summoners to do it. And they got Watch in the meantime as well, too. So CJ with Watch down, their health may be just high enough to try this Baron.
Still super risky because Chaos Storm is available.
Yeah, Ambition needs to go home and then come back with his ult.
There's no Tibbers, though, so that's nice. But
well, I mean, again, like if Ambition can go home, heal up, and then come back with his ultimate, which is, I think, what he's going to do here. Whoa, they totally caught Duke. Oh, man, what a huge mistake for Najin. Mad Life blocking a lot of the attacks coming in from Najin there. Watches back up, but there's a knockup. They're just going to pick apart Najin piece by piece. There goes Oku. Slow down onto Goon, gets exhausted. They're going to keep chasing him. Shy trying to cut him off, but they may decide to turn.
Mad Life
got very low.
Barely living at the edge of that Chaos Storm. Goon now has no ultimate. They're kind of running out of tools, but Ambition and the rest of CJ are running out of HP.
Yeah, I don't know about this, man. They're going to try to zone Watch, but this Baron is very risky. Mad Life really can't even survive being hit by Baron right now. They're going to get it anyway, though.
Yeah, and looks like they have to go back to deal with this naked inhibitor in the bottom lane, and they're just not confident of going in while Coco is still there and has relatively high HP. He's set up for a nice little zone there, but eventually realized no one was coming, so reset his soldiers into the Baron pit to burst it down for the last little bit of HP.
Yep. And CJ nearly 10k gold ahead right now with the Baron, with three dragons and a big turret lead as well. And now we'll see if they can transition this after they take their fourth dragon into some pressure on the tier 2 in mid.
Or just go for the inhibitor. Why not at this point?
Could do that too.
Take it out. Play confidently around that objective and just keep on rolling straight through before you start to siege any other aspects of the base.
Yep. It's like they're going to walk right in. Najin has their ults up again. CJ needs to be a little bit careful with this. That inhibitor took so much damage so fast. Wow. Yep, there it goes. I mean, there it goes. There.
You got it. Eventually.
Yeah. I thought we were going to see it get burst again, but nope. And CJ just waltzes out. They could go for that fourth dragon now if they want to. Or just go for mid lane. I mean, you've got that Baron buff. You might as well just keep sieging, I suppose.
No reason to go back quite yet.
Yeah.
You're pretty much at full HP. You have an Azir turret to cover your rear.
Azir to cover the rear.
Azir in the rear.
That's not what I was saying, but you went there.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much. And CJ just steamrolling their way into the base. There goes inhibitor number two. And at this point, doesn't look like there's a whole lot that Najin can do unless they get an absolutely perfect team fight.
Well, even then, two inhibitors down, extraordinarily difficult to come back.
Yeah.
There's going to be a fourth dragon here, so all CJ will have to do is wait another 6 minutes to get number five and force a favorable team fight around that objective.
Working quite well. There it is, dragon number four for CJ. And they're still pushing.
No one wants to go back. They have so much money. But I guess recalls are just out of the question right now.
Well, you might as well get every little ounce of that Baron buff you can.
Every little drop of the buff.
That's right.
Squeeze it out.
Baron is good to the last drop.
Slather it all over the minions.
Get the last gank. Whoa, Goon, get some damage onto Ambition. This could be GP. It. Teleport coming in. They're going to from behind. Emperor's Divide used fairly early. A lot of damage onto, whoa, actually, Space taken out immediately. CJ on the disengage now. Duke wades through the team. They're not going to follow him, though. They need to get out of there.
Yeah, Shy did a good enough job of keeping the Maokai off that back line so that they can only take Space out, who was pretty far forward playing it, but they do get the tower in the end, so it's not that big of a deal that Space is going to die because there's absolutely nothing right now that Najin can take, and they use the Baron to the maximum possible degree. They exposed another inhibitor in the end.
Yep, so CJ's still way ahead. They did a lot with that Baron buff. And losing space, eh, it happens.
This is first time dying, you know.
Yeah.
It's okay.
37 minutes into a game on Graves. One death, not bad.
He didn't fulfill his primary mission of just pressing Q and R, though.
Yeah. You want to throw a smoke screen in there, too, just to make things a bit awkward.
The smoke screen always makes things awkward, though. Yeah. I try to do that at parties sometimes. And
you just throw up the smoke screen?
Just throw up the smoke screen. Nobody ever really appreciates it.
Well, it wouldn't be so bad, except for you always wear your cape and you, like, raise your arms and say, I'm the Batman, and everyone's just kind of confused. I don't get it.
I only did that one time.
It was very memorable. Or you just, like, wear your hunchback costume and say, I'm Richard III.
There wasn't a lot of smoke in that one,
My
though.
Kingdom for a Horse. Well, I don't know. Battlefields can get quite smoky. Maybe not Middle Ages battlefields.
Yeah, not medieval ones.
Hey, what if you, like, shoot fire arrows at people?
What if you do, indeed?
Yeah. Trumps. Well, gravity field, as soon as that's gone, CJ's going to go in. There's not a lot stopping them at this point.
Besides the lack of super minion pressure, so they just want to be patient here. There's no need to go in that far, and you can see space. Ow. Actually playing this very far back this time.
Yeah, Coco getting poked pretty hard. Yeah, Goong's doing a good job of zoning out CJ here, but the super minions are coming in mid-bottom, so this can only last so long.
Maybe it'll last a little bit longer. CJ didn't prep the waves in the other lanes very well heading into this siege. But it's okay. Their patience will most likely be rewarded in the end.
Yep. Oh, here come the minions now. CJ moving in. Will Najin decide to engage on this watch? Tries to land a Q. Can't do it. There's Sivir of Ultimate. Duke goes in on the Mad Life right away. Coco poking from the side. Great equalizer again from Shy. Pure trying to get something happening over the wall, but doesn't do it. Just gets poked out. Goodbye, Duke. Exhaust onto Goong as well. CJ a bit low.
Oh,
Emperor's Divine catches everybody. Immediate zone news from Coco just to keep himself safe. Double kill, though, for Goong. Turns it around, but a double kill for OQ as well.
And wow, four members dying. Coco couldn't actually finish anyone off when he went in.
Man, that really looked like it was going to be CJ's fight right there. But
well, they over,
Najin coming back.
I think they overcommitted a little bit. So watch Duke here. Duke's going to use the Twisted Advance onto the Braum. And then looks like they have a good zone going, right? And they actually zone people off. So they turn back, kill Duke. Still five members alive from CJ. And here we go. They all walk into a Chaos Storm. Coco gets separated from the rest of his team thanks to the Chaos Storm from Victor. And look at the gravity field as well. Just stunning everybody. And at that point, OQ just gets free ricochet autos into multiple members
of
CJ Entis.
That was the type of fight that Najin's been looking for all game, and they get it now. But is it enough?
No. There's still a Baron in 8 seconds, and there's still a fifth dragon in a minute and a half.
Yeah. CJ already setting up for that Baron, too. Wards and tunnels everywhere.
Wow. That was that gravity field really did a lot of work with the Sivir.
It sure did. They all, I mean, CJ just kind of filed right into it.
Yeah. I mean, the ult from Azir was good, but it was a good reaction from Goong.
Yeah. I was very close to being, like, the end of the game right there.
Some nice, exciting times, Baron dancing. So Najin would like to delay this long enough for the dragon to come up so that they might be able to get at least one of these objectives away from CJ. CJ has to make a decision whether or not they're really going to commit to the Baron first.
Well, they're thinking about it. A lot of wards for Najin, but they do exist. Trying to come from the side, they're going to try to grab watch here. Madlife misses his Q, but Coco gets some decent poke off. Najin having to back away for the moment. Dragon up in 20 seconds, and that would be the fifth dragon for CJ. I think that's suddenly become the priority here. Oh boy, wow. That was very close. If Madlife hadn't shielded that death laser would have done quite a lot of damage. Good spreading by Najin, too, going into this one. Not allowing themselves to be womboed by the combo.
Definitely don't want to be womboed by the combo. So CJ split up right now. Shy is not there with them. They're just going to Walked straight into the base with the Azir turret.
Well, they want to take those inhibitors again.
Look at that. That is clever. So CJ just left behind.
Man.
They have to defend their base.
Yeah. They could take both inhibitors here.
Very, very clever play by CJ. They left Rek'Sai behind just to stop people with Prey Seeker. Najin responding appropriately, though. They're going to take the fifth dragon away from CJ, and that's actually huge at this point. That is a lot of extra damage they just got.
And they're going to get there in time to stop this Baron potentially as well, too. CJ is not killing it very fast. This could be really risky. Oh boy, Watch coming in right now. Once again, something happened. There's the ult for Madlife. Knocks up Goong. They do take the Baron. Equalizer comes through to try to separate Najin away. Shy getting a nice flame splitter in there. Coco taking a lot of damage. Watch ends up in the back lines. Gets very, very low. Emperor's Divide saves Coco for now.
Wow.
A kill for space. Dude, CJ manages to keep most everybody alive.
Yeah, they're
Oki
on
with the double
run,
kill, though.
Look how low the members of Najin are. There's Shy just flashing for him. Why not?
Yeah. Trying to take up here over the wall, gets him with the flame spitter. And meanwhile, this wave up in top is actually taken. And CJ needs to like win the game right here.
No, they could choose to take another inhibitor if they want to, but they decide it's not going to be worth it. Instead, Rek'Sai will just void rush to deal with these large minion waves that Najin has prepped. So they have to go back. They lose two turrets.
Yeah. A lot of pressure on the CJ now. This game really is becoming quite close. The gold lead's been chopped quite a bit by Najin, and now we're getting to the point again where everybody has the items they're looking for. The gold lead doesn't really matter. Not as much. GA now for Ambition.
Well, Baron at least was taken in the fracas.
Yeah.
So that means that still that pushing power and all three inhibitors exposed from Najin.
Yeah, none for CJ.
Ambition has a GA now. Interesting item choice onto the Rek'Sai. See the money starting to pile up on a lot of these champions. So what is Graves going to buy? He actually sells his QSS for a Banshee's Veil. Very worried about the damage coming in from Goog, and at least he still has some form of spell shield. Crucible also on Madlife, just in case he needs it.
Yeah. Well, Najin pushing aggressively up this mid lane now. Saying, all right, well, CJ, if you want some inhibitors, we're going to take at least your mid one. CJ on the defensive, for the moment, anyway.
Well, yeah, realistically, CJ can just wait the out. They still have the threat of five dragons at any given time. They're still going to be feeling perfectly okay about the fact that they have the mid lane pressure. They can move into the bottom lane with this wave that's developing there at any point. They still have the Baron buff on enough members to empower that siege, and they still have the Azir turret if they need it to cover their flank.
Najin got a little bit separated there, and CJ's going to get a nice opportunity perhaps to take out this bottom inhibitor. They still have that Baron buff on a couple people.
Yep, just riding that really big wave.
Yeah, is Najin going to try to engage on this, though? The Baron minion's doing a lot of work.
And so much zoning from those sand soldiers from Coco, too. Just keeping Watch out of the fight, making sure that Watch walks forward to get in range for a kick. It's not really going to happen.
I didn't get a whole lot of damage onto that turret. Here comes the next wave, though. Baron is gone, apparently.
Space just being super cautious about this, but he's not actually vulnerable to the Lee Sin cues because of that Banshee's Veil.
Yeah.
Nobody managed to pop it.
Well, they get the bottom inhibitor, which is really nice for CJ. Now they can push up this top lane. Basically just wanting to get all the lanes back in their favor right now.
Indeed. So trying to stack up on those super minions. If they can get one more inhibitor, they are going to be in a almost lock victory of a game because they'll get the dragon for sure on the next 2 minutes.
Ambition teleporting back, and he's going to ult right over to his team again. Pure looking for a flank here.
Big Annie.
Yeah, giant Iron Elixir Annie. It'd
be funny if Tibbers got bigger, too.
That'd be awesome. Rito, please.
No, right. No. Don't do that, Doa. Those turn into very bad posts.
Oh, come on. Why not? Well, Najin defending for now. But all CJ needs to do is wait another minute for this dragon, wait until the minions, the super minion waves start pressuring the base.
I feel like we've been here before. Well, the mid inhibitor has respawned now.
Oh, yeah, wow. Still another wave of super minions coming, so CJ can still try to take advantage of it at least.
Yeah, they're also very far away from the dragon at the moment.
Yeah.
So they just want to push this as long as they can, where they can still go back and deal with this dragon. They're trying to buy themselves a very narrow amount of time where they will quickly be able to burst the dragon down.
And they're going to be careful. This is a spot where they lost that last team fight. Tiny bit of damage on the inhibitor. Meanwhile, super minions coming in the bot lane. Oh, Duke getting poked pretty heavily. Watch hit with the Q from Braum as well, too. Yeah, the minion wave in the bottom is a concern, and they're going to get that inhibitor.
Very methodical waiting against Najin and see what they want. They have to be careful in this choke point. Oh, they have to be so careful.
Watch comes in. Oh, immediately gets knocked up by Ambition, though. Nice response to keep their carry safe. Oh, exhaust onto OQ. There's the ultimate for Madlife. Doesn't really hit anything. Gets spell shielded, actually. CJ thinking about backing away. Coco still doing a lot of damage to Pure, but they need to be worried about getting flanked here.
Oh, they just got to get out. Just get to the dragon as fast as possible. You don't want to let these guys take another dragon away from you.
I think they're going to just go right back into the base if they try.
Wow, okay, so bold call from CJ. He's going to force the recall away from the dragon because there are so many minions starting to get into this base, and CJ can just leave now.
Yep, there we go. Oh, actually, they leave OQ there, though. Oh, but Madlife can harass him. There we go.
Braum!
So tanky. Oh, Duke gets caught a little bit. Goon comes in, twist advance, so who catches who? Zonya's for Shy immediately. Whoa, Goon does a ton of damage. Coco doesn't escape. OQ comes in and closes it off. And Najin turning this one around.
Oh, boy.
That could have been the game right there.
Wow, Ambition may try to go for a backdoor. Madlife and Ambition are on a secret mission into the enemy base with super minions.
They've got super minions. If the support in jungle manage to do this, it's going to be amazing.
Well, no, they got Goon one Nexus turret. Well, yeah, but they're real tanky.
Yeah.
Wow, they actually forced the recall. Okay.
Wow. Well, they forced the recall from some of them. They still may lose this inhibitor. In fact, they certainly will.
Yeah, they are. How much are they going to lose, though? Madlife. And, oh, this is going to be so close, Doa.
They're going to lose the inhibitor for sure. Madlife still kind of keeping Goon occupied. Oh, here we go. Ambition on his own, trying to save the game, trying to save this 2-0 for CJ. Gets the knock up onto Duke. There goes one turret. Minions coming out
now,
though.
There's so many super minions.
That's right. Ambition getting very low. He's going to flash away. Does not want to deal with that death timer. There goes the second turret, though. Still 20 seconds. I think Najin's got this.
I don't know. Madlife's nearly back. Ambition coming through. Can they get it?
No, they can't stop them. Najin coming in. Madlife trying to do something. Doesn't have his ult. There goes the Nexus. And Najin, beyond all expectations, manages to take game two.
Wow. What an insane comeback from Najin. I mean, mistakes were made from CJ.
Yeah.
But both teams just trying to threaten the dragon or the base simultaneously, and Madlife does not look happy about that one.
Well, I don't think I would be either. Yeah. They had that game in the bag. And then they kind of mess it up.
Well, I mean, Najin has been very tenacious in their base defense so far today.
Yeah.
And they've been good about dragging it out till the very end and with a couple of kills that allowed them to win.
That's right. So that brings us to game number three between CJ Antis and Najin EM Fire. CJ back on the blue side.
Yeah, Victor, Alistair, and Azir were their bans in game one. I see no reason not to just go ahead and work with those again.
Yeah.
First pick the Rek'Sai if you can. Maybe leave the Alistair up this time, but any banned against Pure, probably that's another way you could go about this, that's for sure.
Well,
I
think
Pure has been very good on any the last couple of games.
Yeah, Pure's been a big threat, so I think that is a good ban. Victor also banned against Goon. List to ban from Najin, so.
CJ could also just go the route of first picking Azir.
Yep. Much safer now that the Goon, or the Goon Victor is out of the way. There's a Ryze ban against CJ.
So,
pretty typical stuff.
Gragas was their last ban in game one when Najin was on the red side. Will they decide to go that route once again?
I think they have to think, too, that if they do first pick the Azir, that they're going to not get the Rek'Sai. So do they want to ban something else?
Yeah, but there's still a lot of junglers available for Ambition.
Alistar.
Okay. So right. They're removing Pure's ability to engage.
Yeah, there's a Gragas ban, so they can choose between the Rek'Sai, the Azir, the Maokai. A lot of good choices for CJ.
Yeah, leaving the Evelynn up, though, they really thought that was a threat in the last game, and I think the Azir has to be your first choice from here. Take it for Coco. Put some Goog on something very different than what we've seen previously. Now the question is, can he play the AP Ezreal?
Well, Sivir Maokai, pretty normal stuff there.
They're just not going to go away. They had the exact same two picks on red side in the first game of this series, and they had those same picks in game two, Najin prioritizing the Sivir in every first round of the draft, no matter the side. They could go with the Graves again, although Space and Madlife didn't do as well in the matchup in game two as they did in the first one.
Still not a bad pick, though.
But without
although the Braum,
without the Annie, there it may go differently.
Yeah. I suppose you could just grab the Rek'Sai here. They don't have a jungler yet.
Oh, you definitely take the Rek'Sai because you know Watch is going to play Evelynn here. That's not even really being called into question. He's just going to kind of defaults to that pick, even though he doesn't tend to do very well into the Rek'Sai matchup. But yeah, Rek'Sai and Janna just going for some peel.
Oh, so Thresh instead.
Okay. I mean, the Thresh does set up picks better, where if they want to take the Graves, and the thing about Thresh is he actually is very squishy early, which does make you vulnerable to Annie all-ins with her high damage. So that I think that's probably the reason why they were picking the Braum, but now that the Annie is off the board, it does free them up to take the Thresh from Madlife.
Well, we've seen the Vel'Koz versus Azir before, but I don't know if we're going to see it today, although I mean, when you think about the Maokai going in and Kennen going in as well, Vel'Koz could get a chance to get a nice ult off, but I don't think we're going to see that. There's the Evelynn.
Still, Pure has been really good at following up flanks of the Kennen. They are going to take it just because they have the Evelynn, they have the Maokai, so they've got the primary engaged down, and Pure is almost certainly going to be able to get some good ults in these scenarios.
I should be able to. So how do you deal with that? Space could take Vayne to try to just position better. Shy on Rumble would make a decent amount of sense.
I mean, the Vayne here, sure, you're going to be able to cut through this front line easier and have more damage in the late game, which has been part of CJ's issue.
Not the Draven.
It could just lane swap with it, of course, and try and handle things that way. These are just troll hovers right now.
Of course.
So the Shen was banned in the last game. Shen and Kog'Maw, a pretty different composition for CJ. They still have the box for some decent coverage on their back line and some decent peel alongside the Azir wall. And they've got Shen, too, in case anybody gets back there just to counteract. But Najin has a lot of ways to engage, and they're going to take the mid lane Ezreal.
That composition for Najin is looking very scary.
I mean, both have their strengths, right? They're going to get the Ezreal. We don't know how good Goong is on this champion.
The poke from CJ, obviously, very strong as well, too, and they have some decent protection for everybody.
Yeah, it's strong, for sure. And they have ways to take out these tanks and sustain team fights. And also remember that Goong does, everyone else besides Goong is going to be going in. But CJ, they don't have a way to really get onto Goong. They don't have, again, we look at the AP Ezreal and you say, well, you probably want some form of targeted CC or flank threat. Well, that doesn't really exist here. And CJ loves to build these compositions with Azir and Shen, where Coco goes all in on Azir and Shen just rides him as he's going into the enemy composition and ulting. So that's maybe the only thing that CJ has to help with this Ezreal, but even then it's going to be difficult to catch Goong out.
Yeah, you'd think Goong would have a pretty easy time dodging around the things like Emperor's Divide and the Sand Soldiers, and they really need to count on like a taunt from Shy or something, I suppose.
Well, yeah, but Shy has to get back there. That's the problem. How do you deliver Shy to the back line? There's not really a good choice to do it.
It's not going to be easy. And here we go. CJ versus Najin, game number three. It's go time. Welcome once again to Summoner's Rift. CJ Entis versus Najin Yemfire in a best of three that could have a major impact on the rest of the season, if not the rest of the year, for both of these organizations.
Yeah. And we could hear the fans, still a few of them left. We are currently in the seventh hour of this broadcast.
It's been a long day. Things have gotten a bit silly.
The pauses, you know. The very long games tonight.
Yeah.
Pretty much every game 45 minutes or more, so it's been a grueling haul, but it has been some very close games, some very exciting games in this series in particular.
Yeah, been exciting for sure. Lots of action.
So Space is here. He thinks it's Christmas time. It's just Christmas in July for everybody today.
It's not Christmas for Maokai this game, though.
The Duke always plays the soccer skin.
Yeah.
Okay, so Goong, a big test for him. How good will he be on this AP Ezreal, a champion that is not really very Goong-y?
Yeah, I mean, he made stuff like Cassiopeia sort of work, but
I mean, I suppose it's like a little bit like AP Nidalee, which he used to be very good at, but
yeah.
Less follow-up for all-in.
Just poking. I think it's the type of champion, though, that mechanically he should be able to handle just fine.
No, Ezreal is not particularly difficult in that regard.
Yeah.
Pretty straightforward. I remember when Riot released him and they were like, the big hype around, he only has skill shots. And you're like, wow. Now everything is skill shots.
Which is good. Click abilities are kind of boring. Except, you know, it's good like Braum's W isn't the skill shot or something. You know? Oh, I missed my ally. Oh, he's dead.
That would suck.
Well, Pyrenokyu should be able to push this lane pretty hard early on.
Yeah, I'm intrigued that they went back to this, by the way, because MadLife, I think, wasn't expecting another one of these bully supports after they banned out Annie and Alistar. Supports that he really had to be worried about getting all in with, but Kennen definitely one of those. So maybe not thinking about that matchup too much right off the bat. And we do see Space and MadLife push right into the tower early on in this game. Shy getting denied a lot of CS by the Maokai, too.
Wow, Goong getting poked really hard by Coco early on as well.
Yeah, we've seen this matchup really be difficult for Ezreal early in the game. Duke just standing there punching Shy whenever he tries to walk up to CS.
It's what you do.
It's what you do if you're a big tree.
Yep, just punch a ninja.
Is punch a ninja.
Or something that is called a ninja. Faux ninja.
That's actually what the feudal samurai lords used to do in Japan. They used to plant ninja punching trees around their compounds. Keeps them safe at night.
Well, you need some practice, too. I mean, you go out and punch the ninja, too. You know?
Would you punch a ninja?
No, man. I'd be afraid of the results. Unless I could, like, take him out in one punch, you know?
I don't even think you'd hit the ninja if you tried to punch him.
Depends on the ninja.
If it was Shen, everybody would hit him.
If the ninja was sleeping, I could totally punch him.
They sleep with one eye open, though.
How do you know? Are you a ninja?
No.
Did you play a ninja in one of your theater performances?
I did not.
In your illustrious acting career?
I did not. No ninja plays. There are actually sadly few ninja adaptations for the stage, Doa.
You know, when you play a ninja in a theater play, there aren't a lot of lines either, you know? You just kind of hide in the shadows.
Kind of defeats the purpose of being on stage because no one could actually see you.
This is true. You wear a mask. Yeah, doesn't work very well for conveying emotion. A lot of body language.
Interpretive dance.
That's right. Ninja interpretive dance. Yeah.
The only interpretive dance you can't see.
Maybe that's for the best. Well, Ambition coming down. They spot him with the ward, so Pirinocchio not really in any real danger here. Meanwhile, an epic battle in top lane.
Tank on tank action.
Yeah.
Sustained through passives and Qs.
See, this Shen skin decided that Shen wasn't flamboyant enough already and decided to have shoulders with like a bunch of spikes on him.
And just be bright red, too. You know what? Just screw it.
Yep. Just give up. Give up completely. Surgeon Shen is probably like the most stealthy of all of them. Because you only see him if you're like really sick. And then you want to see him.
I suppose, depending on his qualifications, how good he is. Yeah. We don't know if he's a great surgeon or not.
It's true.
He spends most of his time running around Summoner's Rift like an idiot.
He doesn't really run. He sort of crab walks, you know? Kind of weird, like, crouching scuttle.
I said, like an idiot, Della.
It's true. Oh, grab onto Pure. Can they get a little bit of trading done? A little bit. Not too bad. They will need Madlife to have some pretty solid hooks this game, that's for sure.
Yeah, I just...
Who do you hook, though?
Well, anybody who you can make a pick on. They have enough damage. They have it well if you can hit them with a spell shield. They have some pick potential with this composition, and they can get some people over walls as well as the long-range damage from Kog'Maw, so it's okay. Like I said, I'm just mostly worried about their late-game team fighting when we compare that to the massive engage that Najin has managed to put up. But Coco really going hard on this turret. I think actually going to dive this. Coco's level 6. I don't know if that's a good idea. I think Ambition should just... He's just looking for Eve right now. He knows Eve is there. Sees her with the Tremor Sense. So I think that was mostly just to protect Coco while he was pushed so far up. But that big minion wave does about 50% of the turret HP damage.
Yeah.
And he's kept Goong locked up, and Goong, all he has is this flask. Pure's going to have to come to the mid lane. He has no mana.
Yeah, it's going to be really tough for Goong to defend this turret. It has to go back. Has to be covered.
Yeah, it's a little bit awkward that Pure is there, but so much chip damage down to the tower already that CJ could just play a very accelerated game and try and get a bunch of that global gold and dragons.
That wouldn't be too surprising, although it looks like we might have a dragon early on for Najin here. Maybe just some wards, too.
Yeah, some wards behind. They want to know whether or not that Ambition is now going to try to solo the dragon by tunneling in.
Right.
That's the idea, as well as see if he's going to be coming through the tri-brush for a gank. So it's kind of a double-duty ward at the back of the dragon pit. Very useful against Rek'Sai in particular.
Well, Goong will be able to grab his blue buff, of course, which will be nice.
Goong also going for, he's not going to try and go for the Sheen. He just really wants to get the AoE wave clear from the Ranger's Trailblazer right now.
Probably a wise thing to do.
Yeah, considering how low his turret already is, yeah. You have to say that's probably a solid choice for him. Space going the more aggressive route here with the Sheen on the Kog'Maw. Oh, Watch is going to get seen.
Oh, that's right. Ambition with the knockup right there. Watch may have to burn a flash to get out of this. Uses his ult to slow down Ambition, but Ambition still chasing. He can still use the tunnel to catch up. Yeah, oh, almost gets him with the knockup, but they do get the flash from Watch. So a nice win there for Ambition. He's going to be able to take the red buff as well.
Yeah, Ambition just waiting once again. Catches Watch out in his own jungle. Does manage to take away one of his buffs, and Goong is just too weak to help right now. He has no combat stats. He has a flask and an amp tome.
Yeah.
So you just cannot fight right now because Coco will absolutely wreck you.
That's the idea.
So Shy, of course, has those double globals. So he has his ultimate right now. Duke does have a TP available to him if he wants to use it. Mission clearing out some pink wards. Shy going to be delayed on his Sunfire Cape, though, because he had to go for a cloak first against Maokai. And that means that he's just not going to have a lot of pressure on the minion wave for a while. Could get his turret chipped out as a result without the AoE wave clear from his items.
And meanwhile, in the bottom lane, OQ with a little bit of an edge, CS-wise. Nice Mystic shot.
I'm a bit surprised that Space decided to go for the Phage first here, or the Sheen first instead of the Phage, because it's just safer in this condition, especially when you could get flashed. That could happen.
It looks like Madlife grabbed Pure and he had to burn his ult to get out of it.
Yeah, not sure what happened to start that scuffle in the bottom side, but
Pure could have tried to go in and Madlife just threw down the box.
Oh wow,
there's
nice
a grab.
Hook.
Exhaust onto OQ could be in a lot of trouble. There's first blood taken by Space. Wow.
And there is Shy also here for some reason.
Just hanging out. Hi, I'm a ninja. They're going to go for Dragon.
Well, they could go for the Dragon, but Ambition is top right now, and they might lose a turret, so they don't have a smite. And that could be a little bit dangerous since Goom does have
a smite. I suppose that is true. It's too bad. That would have been a good opportunity. You don't often see OQ just dying in lane like that.
No. I'm not sure what happened to it. Spell shield there?
Seemed like it was on cooldown. It
must have been.
Yeah. Watch his scene. Oh, Coco taken out on the lantern. And they really do need Madlife to come through big again, you know, on this thresh.
And there he is, standing on a podium. Oh, until he's not.
Yep.
Thresh is no longer number one.
Oh.
Madlife, one of the few people to not use the Samsung Thresh skin. He's probably still bitter that he doesn't actually have a skin from Season 2.
That's true, yeah. He came so close.
Oh, man. Sometimes I like to be mean to Cloud Templar by reminding him about Season 2 World.
So what's your skin again? Oh, yeah. Sorry. Oh, I forgot. I just thought, you know. Sorry, Cloud Templar.
Do you remember Stanley's Nidalee?
Now that's just going too far.
He gets sad.
Yeah.
But you know what? He's made it further in Worlds than any NA team. So he's got
there
that going for him.
It's true. You got to be careful, though, you know? If you're, like, watching a movie with Woong or something, you're like, can you see the screen okay? Oh, sorry. I didn't. That's not what I meant. I just want to make sure there's nothing obstructing your view.
It's okay to look this time.
That's right. Oh, poor Woong. The glance that was heard around the world. Oh, there's mid lane turret for CJ.
Yeah, Madlife sticking around mid too, just so that he could get out with the lantern if absolutely necessary. So a very safe push in that mid lane. Now they're trying to set up for a dragon. Shy's ult is almost back up. His TP is there should he need it.
Yeah, OQ has been a little bit poked by Space as well too, which certainly helps. Madlife probably just going to drop another ward. Or not. Oh, are they going to dive this? Oh, I think they're going to try to catch him. Madlife trying to grab OQ, but with that spell shield up, doesn't even bother trying to
use the Q. Stand United was available. Space was there, so Najin really just falling back out of that mid lane very quickly. Runeglaive is done now, but this blue buff not going to be secured.
Oh, grabbed onto Pure. There's the box as well, too. Pure going really deep for the Sun on Madlife and Ambition. Madlife goes down. Space coming in with a lot of damage, though. Duke in the back line. Space in a bit of trouble. Whoa! Space had everyone push right back onto him, but he flashed over the Emperor's Divide, and now CJ pushing Najin back a little bit. Goom low, but still okay on that Ezreal. Two down on each side, both losing the jungler and the support.
Yes, but CJ has more HP on more people is the problem. Everyone just flashing red except for Duke. They're going to try and finish off this tower, just bottle him up for as long as they can.
Yeah, the minion wave not cooperating, though, and OQ and Duke will escape. Wow, close call.
But turret down, and meanwhile, Najin, or CJ, rather, Ambition, just uses that Void Rush, gets right back into the enemy jungle for another red steal, maintaining supremacy over that objective. Goom very, very low. Has to be cautious. They don't actually get the bottom side turret, but Ambition.
Oh, Ambition tries to go in.
Goom has no mana. Yep. Has to flash.
Ignite does it. And, that was red buff, I believe,
red buff,
actually.
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, so they do get Goong. That's another kill for Ambition.
Wow, Goong really playing with fire there.
A red buff.
Playing with red buff. Almost as dangerous as fire. Oh.
Yep. Oh, hi.
Not sure where that was going.
Just in case.
Precautionary hook. 90 degrees.
That's right. It was just meant to lull them into a false sense of security.
Well, and lulled they have been, Doa.
Apparently. I mean, every game, though, we've seen CJ come out to a lead early on. And
well, and this is one of the big issues with Shen, is that split push becomes so fierce.
That's
when
true.
The teleport is down. The double globals are absolutely devastating, which leads to situations like this. I mean, yes, Goong was not there to contest it either, but there's pretty much no way you can even get close to this dragon right now. You're afraid of any deep wards in your blue side jungle. So if that Shen comes in behind you, which as he falls out of sight from the Maokai could come at any moment and really do a lot of work. And that's really Shen's power in this meta, is having more than twice the amount of time that he can normally have to make plays on the map. Those cooldown buffs, very significant for Shen's ultimate.
You know, it brings an interesting dynamic to what CJ is trying to do this game that they weren't able to do in the first couple of games too. I mean, it's just a very different thing for Najin to have to worry about now.
And they tried to ban it in the last game. This time Shy picks it up. We've seen a bunch of bans against CJ's Shen play. Sometimes Kuvei first picks it.
Oh, a lot of damage onto Space. Gets pulled out on the Lantern, but can he actually escape?
He's got a Shen friend.
It's true.
Stops the True Shot Barouge.
Shen friend.
The Shen friend, he's here. It doesn't matter if he just has to use his ult like that, because he can get back into top lane at any time he wants. Watch looking for a flank. They want to follow this up if they can, but they just don't have the vision. Pink wards in the river for CJ means that they're not going to have enough information to safely make a call about an engage.
Well, CJ's been pretty good about warding this game. It seems like they slipped up a little bit in game number two, but things seem back on track for the most part now.
Yeah, less sloppy plays, and I mean, the pressure just isn't stopping. Goong just continues to have to stand underneath his tier two tower while Coco messes with him with the Azir turret in the mid lane. Keeps him from really doing much of anything, being useful at any point. And as long as the Ezreal is contained, they pretty much, CJ can guarantee that man advantage as long as they have the Shen TP. So they're playing a very safe style at the moment around the Shen ultimate and the Shen teleport, while Duke is bound to a lane.
Meanwhile, Space able to get some decent damage done to this top turret. This is the only tier one left for Najin right now. And it may not last too much longer.
Yeah, that's the crazy thing, is how much Shen opens up the rest of the map for your team, and means that those teleports are doubly important for Duke than they normally are.
Very true. Oh, nice hook over the wall to try to grab Pure. Barely misses. They're still going to be able to get more damage done on this turret. Pure thinking about going in with that slicing maelstrom.
He can't really engage that, though, is the problem. He has to really allow Duke or Watch to open up a team fight and then come through with the follow-up later on.
True enough. Ambition taking a lot of Watch's jungle right now as well, too, preventing
the
other Raptors. They're going to try to engage. Sivirelt used. They're going to bring Space back through the wall, even. Madlife flashing to give that Lantern a little bit of extra distance.
Yeah, great counterplay. Madlife already back and set that up. They didn't have to use any summoners to attempt that play from Najin, so they get something out of it, but those ults maybe enough to actually secure the top lane tier one. Coco just going to single-handedly take the blue buff, because Goong has not been a relevant factor in this game whatsoever. Has his Ludens now, so if he's going to do something, he needs to start doing it soon.
Yeah, we'll see if they can. I mean, right now, CJ with all the pressure.
Yeah, and they also came out to a very healthy gold lead of 4K.
Yeah.
And they've taken away so many buffs from Dodge, and they're going to take away another. Nope, not quite.
Ooh, Ambition Gets hit with that true shot barrage. Nearly gets the red buff, but Goong has to book it out of there.
Yeah, Goong picked it up with the true shot barrage, so that's a nice pickup at the very least for Naj, and maybe now his poke combined with that Luden's Echo will be enough to
Jeez.
Not just hiding her face, just getting entirely off the camera.
She forgot her I Love Watch shirt at home and, like, was really embarrassed.
I'm fortunate that I have not yet seen an I Love Watch shirt.
I haven't either. But she looked like the type.
I'll get you one for Christmas, Noah.
Sure.
Just have a big watch face on it with a bunch of pink hearts around it.
Can I be in a K-pop video with you, Watch, next time I see him? I mean, if Watch can be in a K-pop video, I can certainly get in there.
I don't know what kind of logic that is, Dylan, but okay.
Well, I don't know. I just want to be in a K-pop video.
I think that's it. Well, I certainly don't, so I think K-pop is terrible.
I just feel like in the video game of living in Korea, I feel like being in a K-pop video kind of like is beating the game.
Is it beating the game? It's not just another achievement.
I don't know. It kind of seems like beating at the game.
Is that
level.
The final boss?
K-pop depends.
Is G-Dragon the final boss of Korea?
Depends. I mean, I wouldn't be fighting G-Dragon or something like that.
Why not? Maybe that's what the K-pop video is about.
Doe versus G-Dragon. Yeah, we could do it.
We'll call you D-Dragon just to confuse
D-Dragon.
Everybody. G-Dragon versus D-Dragon.
This sounds like a great idea. Oh.
It'll be a
big poke.
The winner gets to be more dragon.
The ultimate dragon. This is sounding more and more like a wrestling match than a K-pop video.
I'm okay with you wrestling G-Dragon, too.
Oh, hook from nowhere.
The hook from the black.
The darkness produced the hook. Oh, watch. Getting very close here. Onto Ambition. They're going to bring him out with a lantern.
Yeah, Duke's already here. And Shy has both globals to work with for the time being.
Yep, that dragon getting very low. CJ was able to get the first one, and they're pushing him back. Whoa, Big Emperor's Divide. Pure pushing the back line, so Dragon's still doing damage. Goong throws a truth shot barrage through, does a lot of damage to CJ, and that may be enough. Kills coming in for Naj, and Coco still doing work, gets a double kill. Meanwhile, Shy grabs one for himself. Whoa, okay, that was fast and furious, but it was a 2-for-4, and CJ will come away with the Dragon.
OQ came from, where Coco came from in that fight.
From behind.
Let me see. Oh,
yeah,
the old Azir flank. So he just pounds him with the Emperor's Divide. He has the Shen ult shield on him, so he flashes out. And Shen sort of ends up in the back line at that point. Coco ends up eating a bunch of dragon shots, but not before he sets up his sand soldiers. They converge onto Watch.
Space got Goong with the Kog'Maw post-death explosion. Can't dodge everything, can you, Goong? Hilarious. Well, Ambition already has his locket, and that's certainly going to help against Goong, Pure.
He's got a locket in his pocket.
That's right. He's not afraid to use it.
It's not where you normally keep lockets.
No. You normally wear them around your neck, I believe.
Why do the Iron Solari have lockets anyway?
To keep little pictures of their loved ones that they can look at on the battlefield. Obviously.
Aren't the Iron Solari some sort of heavily armored knighthood?
Yeah, maybe.
I don't even know.
Doesn't mean they can't wear lockets.
What is I know there's an Iron Solari Leona skin, but I don't know what the Iron Solari actually do. I don't even know what anybody in the League of Legends world actually does. What does Noxus do? What does Demacia do?
You know what Tom Kench does, man. It's pretty obvious. He eats things.
I'm just saying these countries have no identity.
One's a bad country. One's a good one.
Oh, real deep.
And one's a technological bad country, and one's a technological good country. Oh, nice poke onto OQ. They grab Pure as well, too. Pure completely picked off. Another kill for Space, and there goes the Tier 2 turret.
The old CC train from Hook to Knockup. And Space already with that Trinity Force and the Blade of the Ruined King easily able to power through a Kennen who doesn't even have a catalyst yet for his Righteous Glory.
Yep, they gave Mad Life Hook Champion. Oops.
Time for some quality hooking.
Yep. That's right. He is a great player of those types of champions. Oh, Goon getting a little bit of poking onto space, but he'll be able to heal up just fine. Two-shot barrage not doing enough. And there goes another tier two.
Their siege is just so intense with this Azir and the split pushing too. Now that Shy is just sitting around taking tower shots, I guess.
Yep. He's kind of being a ninja. Oh, nearly being a dead ninja.
It's okay. Just TP back in whenever he wants at this stage. Has that Sunfire Cape now, so getting increasing amounts of pressure. Going for the Randuin's Omen next, interestingly enough. So not trying to go for a completed MR item. Not sure I feel about that against Maokai and Kennen and Ezreal, AP Ezreal. Probably should go ahead and complete a Banshee's Veil before he starts worrying about a Randuin's Omen, considering he's got a long way to go to get in the back line anyway. Sure, he wants to lock down the Ezreal so somebody on his team can kill it, but...
Yeah, I don't think Randuin's too useful.
I don't think so either.
But he bought it anyway.
He's defying me.
It's true.
I'll have to have a chat with him afterwards.
Good luck. Well,
here we
it's
go.
A Baron time for CJ. Here comes Najin. Now, Baron wasn't the most easy objective to take for anybody last game.
Well, Sivir was in the bottom lane, so why not go for it? Ooh, space taking a lot of damage. They're still going to get the Baron.
They will get the Baron. Are they going to win the fight afterwards? They're going to disengage. Nice hook onto Watch. Watch is going to go down very, very low. They're going to take him out. And CJ can be happy with that. No need to chase that one any farther.
OQ just against a Kog'Maw Azir. That is a really fast Baron that can go down. So maybe you don't want to be playing Sivir in the bottom side in that particular situation.
Yeah, he certainly paid for it.
Okay, so now let the great sieging of the remaining tier two begin. CJ coming up with a much more complete victory this time around, 26 minutes in and over 10,000 gold. If they can actually crack the base and finish the game, Najin has proved surprisingly tenacious.
I think they're much better equipped to do that this time around than with Graves.
Yes, they are.
Oh, space, be careful. Oh, gets out on the lantern, still gets stunned by the onslaught of shadows. Hook goes really kind of into midair. Shy gets a taunt onto Watch. Watch getting taken out. Nice knock up by Ambition to secure that kill. Shy picks one up there. And Goon, really poked out. Oh, Ambition. Hits him with the Prey Seeker as well, too.
Well, Goon's never... Oh,
goodbye. Wow, Coco is so good on this Azir.
Yeah, flashing for that kill is really surprising Goon, but he's got so much more damage. And this,
are they going to just go for
it? I mean, they could definitely end the game here. They've
got
so
Baron,
much
man.
Damage.
Wow, OQ gets poked out almost instantly. Pure trying to keep things alive. Duke waits in the back line. Nice Emperor's Divide from Coco.
He bent
Look
that around
that.
The back of the tower to set it up for the kill.
I don't know if they can finish the game here. They don't have the minion wave. They've got some time, though. I don't know. Teleport coming in from Shy. Oh, they're going to go after OQ. They take him out. Space dies in return, but not before they get Watch. And another double kill for Coco. And there's the ace. And that means Goon is coming back. And he's got a lot of poke. And there's not a lot of health for CJ. After all that.
Shy came back in, though, with the TPs. So
Shy can zone well enough.
Well, he's going to start spreading a lot of...
Oh, here comes Pure again. All right, we're going for it. And it looks like they'll have enough to take down the Nexus. Yeah, Madlife and Coco dodging the True Shot Barrage, and that should do it. Pure, they're still fighting. There goes the Nexus, and CJ has just barely enough, and they'll take the match 2-1 after two 45-plus minute games, a 28-minute game for CJ to seal the deal.
Well, by far our fastest match of the night.
Oh, yeah.
A very convincing victory for CJ. They finally found what can work. They played very aggressively with their double globals from the Shen early on. Coco pushed his advantage against the AP Ezreal in the early game, and CJ cleanly takes that one.
Yeah.
Coco's great.
Coco's Azir is incredible.
He's so good.
Yeah.
He's very, very good on that champion. And showing why it is frequently ban-worthy, and you know, Goon never really had an opportunity to show up.